other than a crack of your ass.
Do a quick roll call. Here we got Chris Spencer.
Yes. I looked up, the dude was butt naked.
Yeah,
said, I'm sorry, sir. Our table is kind of busy. You'll have to leave it here.
That was good. Should have said, you know,
and female customers used to bully because they never knew the husband's
sizes. Peep holes and assholes.
They always try to describe him, and you have to try to.
You pick which one first.
Say, yes,
bottom line, I'm looking.
And
over here, we have the beautiful Chris off the plane.
Do you have anything to say?
Steve Murder Jordan.
What does he wear, man? You know, what size? Oh, I don't know. I forgot to look.
Oh, that's the spray paint. Spray tan.
That's
spray tan. And over here we got.
Yo, it's your boy.
There we go.
Microphone. What's that?
Speedy, if anybody told you that's like.
Pour the gravy. Trust me, when I'm out.
You are infecting the ears of America.
When I'm out on the road, the lady's like, I love your voice.
But what about us?
Yeah, what about us, Speedy?
Dude, us in the service.
Well, did you know?
They also love your voice when you go, will that be extra ketchup? napkins?
Extra napkins.
Piano key built my
What did he build?
Piano
key. Buddy Lewis built like a bad used toothbrush, nigga.
You know all the bristles don't roll off the motherfucker?
The one you use to clean your shoes with?
I'm sorry, buddy Lou, but you're in the seat. I'm going to get to you
hey,
late.
No problem.
Hold on for a second.
Cool.
My dear. Over here, we have the beautiful hair.
The poetess.
Smoke weed every day.
Yes, she did this morning. Look
are
at
you
her.
High, poetess?
No, I didn't get my dose yet.
You didn't
she
get
don't
high?
Look high today.
You had a chronic.
Listen, no.
She got the hair straight.
You didn't have a weed waffle this morning?
Yeah, a chronic omelet.
She has a young man must on
whoa,
her.
I heard
a young yes. man must.
They tell me.
They said a little Nissan came by and touched you up.
They telling you.
Buddy trying to sniff on me.
Porter, they say you got your finger in the piggy bank. You're going out with some young dude.
Well,
little,
you know.
Wait, time out. He said a little Nissan came by. A little junior college point guard.
Some nigga from a Division IV college.
Well, actually, no. He's a civil rights attorney. Little 28-year-old. Shit. That's what he told
yeah,
you.
Right.
Yeah, right.
He's in jail
he got
for
the civil rights.
Rights
attorney suit.
He violated someone's civil rights. I think I know him.
Yeah, right.
And over here, taking the place of the irreplaceable Lewis Dix.
Lewis is doing what?
Yeah.
Warm up.
He's cheating on his wife. Dudes that was cheating on his wife. He's re-cheating. Who was this? Who we got?
Buddy Lewis.
Buddy Lewis.
Buddy Lewis.
Does it bother you when people say you look like Madea? Does that bother you?
Not at all.
Which Madea? The jail?
The one that goes to jail. Madea's everywhere.
See, there's too many fucking Madea. It's like Ernest goes to jail. It's like too many of those motherfuckers.
So,
I could care less.
We were in D.C.
Yes, we were. It was.
Amongst 1.8 million people.
That's mm-hmm. absolutely fantastic.
There's about 3,000 bitches who kept asking me about this nigga that choked them out one time.
What?
I think I know this man.
What?
First name Johnny.
Uh-huh. Yes.
Last name Mac.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Middle name motherfucking.
Uh-huh.
And next time he chokes you, you say Johnny.
Johnny motherfucking Mac. And the bitch.
There's a lot of bitches that knew you, Johnny Mac.
They should.
Yeah.
They should.
We're very popular. Believe it or not, this show
is
very popular.
Yes.
It transcends all races and
creeds.
Yeah.
Area codes, zip codes, unemployment lines. It just crosses.
Sexual orientations.
Oh, I don't know what that really means.
It means a faggot's so, lover.
We just you're fag friendly. Try the faggly skies.
They keep my hair pressed, though. I love it.
Your hair do look good and luxurious. I thought you went to Cat Williams' hairstylist. Got a little touch up from the.
I heard he has beef with us now.
Yeah.
I'll give him some crack.
Call
he'll be
Kat.
Okay.
That's hysterical.
I heard call his split ends went straight.
He's mad.
Call us on your belt buckle, Kat.
That girl, that's hysterical.
No, it gets reception.
Call us on your belt buckle. Is it a belt buckle or a boogie board? It's the same time, man.
He took the wheels off his belt.
He said, call him on your belt buckle, nigga. He took the wheels off his belt.
Cat
Cat Williams, call him.
But I'm going to defend Cat Williams.
Why are you mad at us,
though? He's extremely, extremely funny. I've been on Cat Williams at the Oakland days when he was running. When he was running. No, he was running Jeffries.
Yeah, you. Wasn't Ronnie Perry up there?
Perry was up there, J-Dub.
That's when he had the front two teeth missing?
Yeah,
did he really have his teeth missing in that Friday movie?
Yeah, nigga. I thought somebody was kicking field goals through his mouth. And they were all good.
Well, it wasn't Philadelphia. That's for sure.
Wow. Shout out to Lou Dick.
he could dental floss with a jump.
I heard Donovan McNabb come up with his own soft drink.
What's it called?
Choca-Cola. Choca-Cola by Donovan McNabb.
Wait, time out. Donovan had a hell of a game.
Nigga, please.
The defense was awful.
You're the starting quarterback.
Arizona
was just better.
That nigga with the dreadlocks, Fletcher?
Stop it. No.
Johnny Mack, whatever that nigga
name was. That nigga dreadlocks.
Was incredible.
He was. Fitzgerald.
I'm Jamaican, nigga. They dreadlocks.
I think his name was Larry.
They're locks now. Okay. No. Once black soap was sold in front of Howard University, you niggas changed the locks.
Yeah. Do you know why they were called dreadlocks? Because when the Europeans came to Jamaica, they said it looked dreadful to them.
No, that's not true.
That's all the more reason not to call him.
And Speedy, you continue the tradition of being dreadful.
Yeah, Speedy, and I can't believe you went to the inauguration and you didn't know what the fucking dreadlocks come from.
No, that's not true.
Where it came from?
Where's it, Buddy Lewis? Where's it come from?
Buddy Lewis has a degree in fish.
Well, he don't have a degree in hair follicles. How can he speak on this?
But I do have a degree in belly fat. And let me tell you,
where did dreadlocks come from?
Actually, he's partial right. That the Europeans said that this comes from the dread tree. It's a tree that looks like it has the same kind of dreads.
These niggas.
I thought it was the black folks, doing apartheid days back in the whatever.
No,
they was protesting and they would not comb their hair.
Nigga,
so they dread the people. The British have started. They were dreading the sight of the people with the locks.
If you know the answer to this, why don't you call in
877-2-106.
Yeah, the nigga that invented beeswax. Please call in and tell us what the fuck we don't know.
Cat Williams hairstylist. Call
so it. Speaking of that, we're gonna have a great show. And this today's show.
Okay.
We are sponsored by Bud Bowl. Because Bud Bowl is back in a big way. This year
you gonna read
we
it?
Have
Oh, I'm sorry.
Bud Bowl is back in a big way. This year we have some exciting things to fill you in on.
That's right.
First, Bud Light has a secret commercial that would not air on TV during the game. This particular ad will only be available online, so check out budbowl.com or the Bud Bowl Facebook page to learn more. You will not want to miss this one. It will have people talking about it forever. Because Bud Light is also giving away a 46-inch sharp flat-screen TV just in time for the big game. To register, grab your cell and text Bud Bowl to Beers 23377 between now and February 1st. Don't miss your chance to watch the Cardinals and the Steelers battle on a big screen courtesy of Bud Light. Bud Light ads will be available to view on budbowl.com after the game. You will also be able to download and post a secret spot on your Facebook or MySpace page. Bud Light, Bud Bowl. There it is.
What's up? Right.
Hey, Johnny Mack. Let's get it. Hey, Johnny.
Hold on.
There were.
I was struggling.
Oh,
in there.
They took all.
Was good.
Hey. They took all the 2-syllable words out so he could do that.
Johnny Mack.
Yeah, like fat back and hair.
You pronounce the words right. It's your reading rhythm that's a little.
No, he no. The rhythm was. He was just a little loud. I felt like a police officer was reading it. You have the right to remain at Bud Light. Anything you drink will be said and held against you.
Look at this 47-inch sharp TV, punk.
Good job, Johnny Mack.
Good job, Johnny Mack.
Thank you. So, I'm glad we're doing this show because Speedy and Claudio was at the inauguration. I want you to share with our listeners the experience.
Off the chain.
Because Speedy, from what I know, you and Claudio was on the stage.
Pretty much. It was close.
They were sitting in front of Bush.
We were right to the left of Barack. They had two media areas. On the right was television, on the left was radio, and we were probably about 120 feet away. Well, let me, 40 yards away, be exact.
Yeah, right.
I know terms and yards.
You just dance right by him, huh?
Johnny Mack knows grams and
weights and measures. That's what I know.
It was like two downs away. But
it was a short 30-17.
A screen pass. But anyways,
that's hilarious.
Screen pass.
I do know my
shit. So Claudia, and sincereness, you know, and I think it was a beautiful thing that, you know, you two guys represented us properly, because I listened to the show, I watched the show, and I heard the show.
You watched it.
Well, same thing, Speedy. Don't ever fuck up when I'm trying to praise you.
Oh, it's rare.
That's
rare. Fucking RoboCop forehead having a motherfucker.
Why RoboCop? Yeah.
Remember they lift the helmet up, all that forehead?
Okay, okay.
Now let's get back to the series.
You drink your milk, your back wouldn't be fucked up.
I can hide my belt. Back, you belly flop motherfucker.
Okay. Yeah. All right. It's, let's be positive, you guys.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Why, what's with the animosity with you two?
He's
he
mad.
Didn't go. He didn't clear security. I got my badge on
he's
right
still
now.
Still wearing it.
Yeah, but whose name is that?
Who is Dennis Jackson?
And who's that dude on the Kevin Young photo?
And why you got, the
Afro?
Back of the dude picture on?
Yeah. Why he got lip gloss on in the picture?
Yeah. Is that Tyler Perry?
Who's Kevin Yamamoto?
they went for it.
But there were a lot of obstacles getting to where we needed a broadcast because the security there is very tight. I mean, we had to go through security several times.
That's great. It's a good thing.
It was weird because it was one dude would say, hey, can I see your ID? And you give it to him. The next dude would go, can I see your ID? I'm like, I just gave it to your friend.
I don't give a damn. There we go. And by the time we got to where we were, I mean, they said, we basically got there and they said, listen, you've come this far, but it's too late. We're not letting media up to the post. We're like, oh, no, we have to be there. So finally, you know, we got to our post.
It was
and it was so close.
She was a lady dude.
We were so
close.
I know
you talked to her real sweet, didn't you? The lady dude. I know you. Yeah, this is Speedy. Let me go to the media. I have some chicken in my pocket.
No, they said they had a...
Hey, Buddy Lewis, if anybody ever shot at you before, because you just ruined a good moment. But keep going.
So anyway...
Is the D.C. sniper still out?
Yeah, somebody bail that nigga out.
You going next week.
I'm going to bail that nigga out and give him some bullets.
So
anyways,
how was like that Monday night when I saw it on HBO and shit, you know, with had performances and all that stuff? How was that?
Well, we didn't go to that. I didn't
stay
see
stay focused.
They weren't invited to any
of
the
we didn't
balls.
See that. We didn't get to go. We
had better credentials than everybody.
Well, yeah, we had great credentials. We just didn't actually get down to the performance.
But once
Claudia wasn't invited to any balls, just to touch on it.
She was the fundler at the ball.
But Tuesday.
They called her fingertips.
Tuesday was
so
bananas.
Yeah, Tuesday was
off the chain. It was so many people. And they tried to ask us, you know, is it more black? Is it more white? And it would just look like a lot of people said, look, I'm tired of the way this thing's been going. Let's change it. And then as far as you can see, to the Washington Monument and past it, people were standing.
The crowd stretched back 3 miles.
Yeah.
Right. And packed.
Three miles
of people, shoulder to shoulder.
Obviously, Speedy didn't run that far, but keep going.
Speedy's row kind of eliminated a lot of people, but no. Yeah, no, but it stretched back 3 miles, and it was extremely
so
cold.
So being there and hearing this guy being sworn in and seeing, was it an emotional moment or was it a powerful moment? Like you was overcame by the power of being in this guy's presence. I mean,
when he finally walked through, that's when it hit you and everybody screamed. They were already standing up and they were cheering. We were told, you know, not told not to, but this one guy called into my show on Wednesday and said, are we going to stop talking about Bush? So I promised I wouldn't say anything about Bush. But when Bush came out, they booed him, and then people start singing
that song, na na na.
Yeah,
yeah.
So, but when Barack came out, people were just crying. They were standing up. People that could stand up. There were old people wrapped up in that aluminum foil. They looked like little Negro
like
hot
old
pockets.
Baked potatoes.
Negro hot pockets.
But those people. But there was
a whole bunch of reheated cooking Happy Meals and shit.
There were a section of people that were close that clearly had to be there since probably 3-4 o'clock in the morning, and they were so cold. And there were a lot of elderly
kids,
people that you
lot
know.
Of kids.
The elderly people that were definitely there for many many hours. Yeah. You could tell.
Also, earlier you got there, the closer.
I lived
in
D.C. Nobody could deter them
a lot of those kids were, but I'm just saying, a lot of those kids were, they were out there because they had no parents. You know, they don't have no, you know, discipline in D.C. So a lot of those kids were just.
Yeah, you know, right. Filling up the Louis Dick shoes.
No, I'm serious.
Irrelevancy.
I like your hair.
Give it up for Buddy Lewis.
I like rainbows.
But,
random.
But you saw a lot of kids. You saw a lot of elderly people.
Right.
You saw a lot of whites. You saw a lot of black. And everybody, it was like a big family reunion, because every time you saw somebody, they was like, hey, how you doing? You good? And it was that way on the plane. We're on the plane. It was that way. And coming back home, people talked to you. where normally, you know, you get on a plane, you chill, or you get where you're going, nobody says anything. But it was beautiful.
Was the plane black?
So
pretty much.
A lot of black folks. It's the most black people I've seen. There were way more black people than anything, but there was definitely a mix of people.
Yeah, you saw it on TV.
They put Rock's name on we saw it on, not saw it, but we were told they were on condoms. They had it on a pamper.
Never let
say yes, we can, yeah. Yes, we can.
I'm coming through.
Condom.
Yeah, it's all about change and get a new bitch.
Diapers. There was a Barack Obama hand puppet, which I was going to get for you, but I was way too cold to stop.
Right.
It was just
nice. How cold was it?
They said it was 20, but it really felt like it was about five degrees.
We sat in our seat from 10 in the morning.
Yeah, explain to everybody how close you guys were. Tell them the proximity.
We were about 120 feet away. If you go to the Facebook page, my Facebook page, I have a lot of pictures of just how close. And on my MySpace page, you can check it out. Yeah. And we have very clear pictures of Barack. I zoomed in on Bush. You can see him giving the dirty looks at Barack.
Oh, and that was the other thing.
Every time Barack got applause, he had...
Bush would stare at him.
His body language was like...
I used to get those.
Like that, you know? I said he reminded me of the dude on Gladiator, like Joaquin Phoenix's character.
Oh,
why don't they love
me
like they love him? You know, he seemed like he was so jealous.
But it was once Barack walked out, it was the most incredible fit because he just stood there. And he took it in.
So
have you guys seen the pictures from around the world of people watching from different countries? They had one picture where it was a little TV in a little village, and all the people in the village watched this one
and starving at the same time.
So it was one dude.
Should have been watching the cooking channel, the hungry motherfucker.
it was one dude in the back going, "What'd he say?"
But it was just like.
So when did it hit you? I mean, you know, your experience of being there, because it's never going to happen again in our lifetime, because it's only going to be one first time. So when did it hit you that you was watching, and how did you feel when you realized you was watching firsthand or was participating in a moment of history?
Well, as it's happening, it's sort of surreal, and it's just like, you don't really, it doesn't really sink in. But really, when I saw Michelle and Barack walking in the parade after that and Brave in the Cold, and Bush, when he was in his parade, inaugural parade, I think he got, you know, he rolled down the window a little bit. But they got out, took to the streets, they walked, they let the people talk to him.
How cold
and then
was.
When you see that, you're like, damn, he's just so smooth and so loved. It's got to be the best feeling in the world.
Because we walked to McDonald's, and we were so cold. And then when I saw her in basically a skirt and shoes and no socks
and them green gloves,
she had
on stock.
Green gloves. Oh, she did.
But that doesn't do much because I had five layers of.
So the
on
fact
my
that they even did that, and then too, there were so many threats on his life that I didn't think he would do that. And
well,
the fact
he,
that he got
well,
out
he did
and
have
walked.
On a bulletproof. Clothing, they said.
Yeah, but he ain't on a bulletproof fade. They could.
But
did you see the Cadillac though? The Cadillac was on.
The feeling is like this. It's like, you know, we talk about it, and it's been a lot of hip hop songs, and we're never gonna have a black president, and Bill Clinton is the best we're gonna get, and we should just be happy with that. And then when you see this smooth brother come out, and people love him, not just us, the white people are just like. Like, the love for him is just amazing.
Right.
I would love to feel, like, a tenth of what he feels just for, like, a minute, just to see how
you
that feels.
You do it every Super Bowl.
And all the combines.
But, seriously, we're talking about the present right now.
You're right, you're right.
So let's be focused.
I don't want to Buddy Lewis you. I'm sorry.
You guys have been, but I'm trying to be serious. But, seriously, the feeling that, you know, he must feel, like, just talk about being at the top of the world.
Did you cry, Claudia?
Towards the end, it's a little bit, but I cried more at the Democratic Convention. This, for me, it kind of sunk in when I got home and I saw him sign 3 executive orders on his first day in office.
Saw that too.
I'm like, damn, he's just the smoothest brother ever. And it's just like,
not really, but
I hope, yes, he is. And I feel like,
second.
You should have saw me working over the weekend.
No, listen. Yes. I just feel like, I just hope he's just an inspiration for more people to kind of go down that path to get into politics and not just having a hot 16 bars, a jump shot, or a quick 40 time. I think I want to start dating politicians.
There you go.
Yeah. I'm retired from sports.
And I must say, looking at all the politicians up there, they were rock stars, and he was the biggest rock star of them all.
Right.
And when he came out, I mean, it was just, you see, it was a few black people. You had Jesse Jackson Jr. was up there where he was.
Why?
So it was a few black people, but to look and see one black man is running this whole thing, it was a moment. It was.
Did you cry, Speedy? You got emotional.
I shouldn't say
cry. Was you emotional? You felt the power, and you felt like
a little gravy came down.
Yeah. A little gravy.
Yeah,
a little bouillabaisse sauce leaked out your eyes.
Yeah. Call in 877-210-6106. If you were there, and let us know what position you were. A lot of people called in on my show, and one guy called in and said he was right by the tower. You ain't see shit.
Call from
the
Cleveland.
Twin Towers.
He said, y'all didn't see me?
I said,
that nigga called from the Watchtowers, nigga. This nigga was nowhere near D.C.
But I think I would have went regardless, and I would have stood right where everybody else stood because I would have wanted to see that.
There's people that were very far away that are still just as happy as we were to be there.
Now, there was 1,000 people that didn't get a chance.
No.
See. It was
10,000. With the purple tickets. They were held up in the tunnel.
They got held up in the tunnel because some people ran past security.
Right.
Wow. So they said, we're going to lock it down. And so people who volunteered for Barack and volunteered, these high school students who came a long way,
they never got it.
A lot of the foot soldiers, a lot of people that went door to door for Barack, this was their big payoff because of some people. But from what I know,
the parade made up for some of that.
Well, a lot of people couldn't get to the parade that paid for tickets to the parade because the lines were too long. So there were some.
Well, that's a beautiful thing that Barack would draw such a crowd like that. Of course, a few people are going to get left out. You know, you pay for this to pay for that. It wasn't done on purposely, but from what I heard, it was like 3, 4, 5 million people there.
It was close to 2 million that was actually there. Maybe a million actually came out, like trying to get on the because we tried to go back and get onto the train to go back to our hotel.
Right.
It was a soup line. Like the 40s.
They didn't let you on ahead of weight limit?
Now we're being serious.
We is being serious.
Anyway, it was a long-ass line, like the soup lines in the 20s, like that. And people were standing like, just to get on the train to go home. We tried to catch a cab. And every time we looked for a cab, somebody was already in it. We were like, can we get in?
I'm not laughing right now.
Why not?
But it was cool.
I got a very up-close and personal look of all the communities and streets in Washington, D.C. We saw a lot of the city.
We walked around. And somebody
what do you mean? Oh, so you have to walk.
We got to do this. We got to do this, John. Because there was a married couple and their brother who saw me and Claudia walking around. They thought we were arguing, like we were a couple.
This nigga wanted to walk across a bridge and didn't know where it leads. He didn't know what state it was going to. Nothing.
I was messed up with so-called. So I go, Claudia, let's walk over. She said, I'm not walking nowhere. So this lady rolls the window down and goes, do y'all need to find out where you are? You want to sit in the car with us? So they let us sit in the car with them until Chris Colbert came and got us. My man Rob at the hotel.
Sheraton Suites.
At the Sheraton Suite. When I say he took care of us, man, this brother came and he rode me to the airport. And it's like, 30 minutes away. Mm-hmm. He was mad cool. He took care of us at the hotel. Everybody was cool. When he found out we were with Foxhole, he goes, who's the dude with the 10 kids? Claudia goes, Speedy. He's like, oh, my man.
Yeah.
You famous for 10 kids.
10 kids.
That's what he thought. But yeah, we had come to a crossroads. Speedy wanted to take the bridge. I didn't want to. I felt like two slaves. What he wanted to go back south. I want to go north. And I'm like, nah, nigga, it's this way.
Fuck Harriet Tubman. I'm going back.
Then we go to McDonald's, and inside of McDonald's, it's packed. I mean, it's like, I thought he was giving away government cheese. And so some old dude sees me with Claudia, because every dude thought I was with Claudia. He go, hey, man, yo.
Now, how did that make you feel, Speedy, that you had been
with? No, how did that make Claudia feel?
Yeah, really. So this little homeless dude, now he looked like Gator. He was getting his little Gator shuffle on. He looks at Claudia and goes, oh, you is so fine. Hey, my man, your wife is beautiful. And
hey, what did you say, Speedy?
I said.
He claimed it.
I said, bitch, get over here. Let's eat, man.
Pay for the Big Mac, bitch.
And then he turns around and asks Claudia for $4. I'm like, damn, how the homeless get the $4?
I'm showing Chris Spencer a picture of how close we were. Wow, that was our perspective of the podium. So we were like just right here. That's the TV version. And we were this close. Like,
which your MySpace page for people to go see?
MySpace.com/TheRealClaudiaJordan. You can just go check
as
it out.
As opposed to?
The fake ones.
Okay.
The real hair, Claudia. Hey, and on that note, we're going to take a quick break.
Why?
We're going to take a quick break and come right back, and we're going to talk about the inauguration and some other beautiful things that's going down. And I really appreciate Claudia and Speedy being down there. You guys did a great job.
And we're going to thank Sirius Radio and XM Radio for letting
us. I've already done that. Fuck that. We're going to take a quick break, come right back. There it is.
Music.
You only got to let one person leave.
Still on.
No, you still on.
Yeah, we back. We back. And right now, we're going to the beautiful, sexy, vibrations. Claudia. Straight out of D.C.
Short. Okay.
Are you talking about the vibrator?
Oh, I was trying to say vibrations.
I don't use a vibrator.
Vivacious.
I was trying to say vibrations for vibrator. Let me do my joke. I know what I'm
doing. Maybe you're part Mexican. They pronounce B's and B's.
I know what the vibe is here.
Oh.
You got the vibe.
He gets sensitive if anything. Yeah, okay.
Nah, I love Chris Spencer. Go ahead, Claudia.
Okay, the holidays are over, and that means that Valentine's Day will be here before you know it. And most guys won't be ready. Audemars Piguet, the world's oldest luxury watchmaker, still in the hands of his founding family, will make this holiday timeless. Audemars Piguet invites you to enter and win his and her Audemars Piguet watches this Valentine's Day on Sirius.com/AP. Not familiar with Audemars Piguet? AP is known for its daring achievements, record number of world's firsts, and celebrity loyalties. Celebrity loyalties, my bad. One lucky listener will win a pair of Audemars Piguet Royal Oak watches with a combined value of almost $25,000. His watch is a classic in stainless steel with its iconic octagonal bezel. Her Royal Oak has the added sparkle of 32 diamonds. Make this Valentine's Day one to remember. Enter today and win a pair of Audemars Piguet Royal Oak watches this Valentine's Day on Sirius.com/AP. No purchase necessary. Must be at least 18 and a resident of the lower 48 states or D.C. to enter. Entry deadline is February 12th, 2009. See official rules at Sirius.com/AP.
Woo, I'm glad you read that, because the thought of Johnny Mac reading that is scary.
Yeah, the name is sad. What was the name of it?
As soon as you got the Octagon. Octagon.
As soon as I would have got to the 25,000, I would have started selling it. Like, I'm going to sell
Audemars Piguet.
And I actually went to the website.
You got one on right now?
Oh. I went to the website and I saw you got to go under Foxhole to register. So just register. It's no obligation.
So how do you do that, to register for that?
You just go to the Sirius.com website and then you go under Foxhole, and then there's a little ad there for you to click on for the watches.
Right.
So do that so they know that y'all listening.
Yeah, we're giving them away. We're giving them away.
You're going to love the watch. Trust me. I'm telling you. You're going to.
What about the beer, John?
It's going to be great on the black. Speaking of the beer, Bud Bowl is back.
Oh, shit.
In a big way this year, and we have some exciting things to fill you in on. First, Bud Light has a secret commercial that will not be aired on TV during the game. This particular ad would only be available online. So check out BudBowl.com or the Bud Bowl Facebook page to learn more. You would not want to miss this one. It's going to have people talking about it all day, every day, because Bud Light is also giving away a 46-inch sharp flat-screen TV. Just in time for the big game. To register, grab your cell and text Bud Bowl to Beers 23377 between now and February the 1st. Don't miss your chance to watch the Cardinals and the Steelers battle on the big screen TV courtesy of Bud Light. And all of the Bud Light ads will be available to view on BudBowl.com after the game. You will also be able to download and post a secret spot on your Facebook or MySpace page. Bud Bowl is back.
Wow. Johnny Mac.
Stella got a girl back.
And speaking of the big game, you guys know that you have to say the big game when you're promoting. You can't use Super Bowl to promote, like, items. Like, people can't say, oh, for the Super Bowl, go out and get this, you know.
Why not?
It's a trademark issue.
Well, for the Super Bowl, I'm going to be hosting a party at a Hard Rock
I'm
going to
have some super bitches at the Super Bowl.
Well, at the Bowl Super, I'm going to be doing some things.
That Floyd, is so corny.
I actually am hosting a party at Floyd's at the Hard Rock Cafe Friday night.
In Florida?
Vegas? Oh, in Florida.
At the Super Bowl, I'm hosting a party at Floyd's at the Hard Rock Cafe.
Floyd's. Are you just hosting Floyd? That's what
No, that would be you, faggot.
Ooh, shit. Hey, we're going to go
hit you with the faggot.
Figot.
I had taken about 3 hits already, so shit. Time me to retaliate.
He's a fat fat.
He's a figure, a hairy big figure.
His T-cell count is still up.
I've been nice to you, Buddy Lewis.
Buddy Lewis, did that offend you when she called you a figure?
No, I don't. You're used to it? Offended. I'm used to dirty, rotten whores trying to say things about me.
Ooh, well, that's all you can get around is dirty, rotten whores.
I'm around you?
Not really. You just showed up.
Tune in next week.
Same thing.
Tune in next week for Diamond Double D and Buddy Lewis.
Wait, is it something
thing.
About... Is it
Press bowl.
Nigga, I get a check.
Wait, Johnny Mac, is it something about this seat?
You volunteered.
And for you out there, Buddy Lewis is sitting in Lewis Dick's seat.
I didn't want to sit here.
Yes, you did.
No, I didn't.
Yeah. I think that seat is possessed.
You sit where you can get.
You'd rather sit at the buffet table?
That's the whole hater seat.
Yo, we got a caller. Hey. We got a caller who was at the inauguration. We got my man Alonzo from Virginia. What's up, Alonzo?
You got it, man. What's going on?
What's up with it?
So where were you at, man?
I was there, part of the People's Inauguration Project. Active duty military, not a disabled veterans, man. It was all good. I'm gonna tell you, the aura, the feeling, you know, and the part that upsets me the most is that. Mentioned it once on the news. I heard it on the news just for a hot second, and then they went to something else. All those people there, and not one incident.
No one was
arrested for anything. No. You didn't hear about no bad stuff happening. Mm. It's a sad thing that we know we can do it. That day, those couple of days, prove to the world that we can do it. And you know, another part about it that makes it all surreal is the fact that it took a direct descendant of Africa to do all this.
I like that.
It's amazing. You know, and there's a lot of black people, since he brought that up, there's a lot of black, well, not a lot of black people, but I've heard a few people say that, you know,
it's like one or two people.
Well, maybe from that's a lot for to be said by two people.
Said
for
what?
To me directly that they feel like Barack is not black, that he's not he doesn't have slave lineage, that he comes from an immigrant. Does that really make a difference?
Who those niggas were slaves. That's why they said that.
They're trying to take
Aaron
away
Magruder,
our...
Aaron Magruder came
count.
Out.
He don't count. He don't
count. Anyway, ain't he Puerto Rican?
He don't care. Yeah. Let me make sure I do this too, Johnny. You got to give mad love to the military because they had to stand out there, if I'm not mistaken, from Sunday until
like
20, the end.
They like 24-hour shifts.
To the end.
That's their job.
No. They had to stand on corners.
Shit.
And they stood there by themselves in the cold. So we're going to give mad love to the military who did
Thank
that.
Thank you,
man.
Brother.
Yeah.
And to these people out there that are trying to take away from the significance of Barack being black. And let's dissect how black he is. For years, one drop was enough to pollute you to be black. Now they're trying to take away. Well, at least half. You know what? That's fucking enough.
Yeah, his father's from Kenya. We'll give a fuck. It's just too much. Just be happy that the man is in there, and I appreciate it, nigga. Let me tell you how stupid people are.
Let's not split.
Some bitch.
What was it, Johnny?
This bitch, cankersaw of a whore, texted me said. And Martin Luther King was assassinated in 1965. Barack is our 44th president, which equals 2009. Like, no, bitch. Martin Luther King was killed in 1968. You stupid bitch. If you're going to send some knowledge, at least know some about some knowledge.
At least Google search it, huh?
God damn, bitch.
Did you add it up after you figured that out?
I said bitch 16 times when I sent her that. I know, and she put God on it. See how God's working? Like, no, that's not God working. God did not tell my man to kill Martin Luther King. Get your facts together, black folks, before you send out these goddamn texts and all you niggas calling in.
How about this? Just shut the fuck up with all the negativity.
And go back to mopping floors, nigga.
Yes, let us just embrace.
All you niggas ain't come up.
Let's embrace what we got going on, and let's stop trying to find ways to make this a negative.
Yeah, nigga, get back in the back and make the smoothie, nigga. That's your job.
Go cut the grass.
That's your job, nigga.
Go cut the grass.
I hate that we have to be excited that nothing happened.
Ooh, that's what I'm about to say.
But whenever there's a large gathering of
people. It's like a nigga saying, I take care of my kids. That's like Chris Rock.
Yeah.
Nigga, do you want a cookie?
You're supposed to, nigga.
Yeah.
So, but now, with this being said, we have events coming up. We have the Super Bowl. A lot of black people are going to go.
We have
We have the All-Star game coming up, which last year in Vegas, a lot of people got killed. I don't know if people know that. So if we can get through having 1.8 million people together.
And that's why it makes the news, because that's not what's supposed to happen. What was supposed to happen, you go to D.C., it's peace and calm. That's supposed to happen. So when you go out there and fuck it all up, that's why it makes the news.
Well, I think part of that, John, is because you didn't come, so that's why it was.
I was going to fuck it up, Speedy. I was going to rob at least 2.5 people, get my strong arm love on. I give a shout out to the FBI for saying no. They would have fucked it up.
I heard niggas was acting up at the Biggie, Notorious.
I went to the Notorious, and it was this black couple behind me. It was four black people behind me. Uh-huh. Nigga.
Talking.
Motherfucker. They kept talking.
I know. What'd you say, John?
I said, nigga. I said, my man, I didn't come here to hear you.
You came here to hear the music.
Right now, nigga, you told nigga he was being notorious by talking behind you.
Then you had to threaten the nigga at the movie theater. I said, you see the coffin? You're going to be next, nigga.
And by the way, Notorious.
You say one more goddamn word.
Notorious grossed $21.5 million.
I saw it twice.
It's opening weekend.
George
it was an
Tillman,
excellent
Bob
movie.
Title,
excellent
friends
movie.
Of mine.
I saw it twice. And if you ain't seen it, please go out there and see it.
Great movie.
It's a couple of Definitely. Moments in there in Notorious, and I got weak.
In Sacramento?
I got weak when they said, when they played Who Shot You? Ooh, I thought I got weak. I didn't cry.
Yeah, I heard the Biggie character was kind of goofy. That's what Jamie was saying.
The what was?
Remember he was saying the guy who played Biggie.
No, he was good.
He was good. Wasn't Jamie saying?
I think all the characters.
We just thought it was Fox just said. Actors. Thought it was the.
If you ever got a chance to see the movie, it's a really really good movie for you to see.
How we go from
Rock
to the Tour?
You know, it captures. You know.
Hey, it's blackness, man. The black people, powerful black movie, doing powerful things. Barack is all about change.
Okay. And I like to say,
well, Dad's mama and his mama get together for
it. I like to
say, there's a lot of positive things happen. Like, you changed your bra size. That's positive.
It was a black bra.
I would say,
I gave it to black and white.
Black people.
Don't bring me in this.
I gave it to
your cup is your cup.
His
right?
cup running over.
Yeah, I know.
Yo, we got another caller.
You gun jammed.
We got a beautiful young lady named Ebony.
Now, how you know from, she's cute?
Her name is Ebony. She's got to be beautiful. Okay. You don't name ugly kids Ebony.
Nah, you name them Ebony.
Yeah, you call them hideous. And
she dropped.
That's stinking it. I done gave her all these props and she done dropped.
What were you going to say, Claudia? I just want to say to black folks, because, you know, we consider ourselves brothers and sisters. If any time that needs to be applied, it should be now. And when you're in the movie theater or around, you see your brothers and sisters acting up and doing wrong, we should check them because we are responsible. We are our brother's people, even more so right now. So if you see people fucking up, having illegitimate kids, eating too much cholesterol, all kinds of stuff.
He's right there, Claudia.
Oh, she's talking about Speedy. I didn't know that she was talking about Speedy.
No.
I thought she was talking about our next caller. We got another caller from Canada. We'd like to welcome in all our Canada listeners. My boy John is calling in. John, show light.
Hey, what's happening, y'all? Allow me to give y'all some praise first and foremost, man, because I'm telling you, from y'all got on the air to now, y'all are like one of the best shows on Sirius Satellite Radio.
Well, who's better?
Thank you, man.
Yeah. Oh, hey, well, John, you said one of the best.
We're the best.
Say what?
Infidel. You said one of the best.
Well, y'all are my two favorites, man. I'm not going to take
who's
like,
the Who's the other one?
Who's the other favorite?
I listen to Howard Stern, but, you know, it's y'all two.
Okay. We've heard of him.
Him and his curly mullet.
But I was at the inauguration. That's the real point. And I took my kids. Now my daughter's 5. My son is 2. Wow. You know, and my wife and we used to live in D.C. right, and we just moved to Atlanta about a year and a half ago. And I was pissed. I had to go back. You know, from me living there, but it was worth the drive, man. And we came up, took the kids, and it was
Where were you standing at in the crowd?
I was standing on 14th. And 14th in the mall, which is like right in front of the Washington Monument. So I couldn't see.
Oh, you was in Virginia.
Yeah, I was back.
We gotta ask Buddy Lewis. How far was that, Buddy?
Woo. No, we took a picture of the porta potties.
Now let me ask you a question. They were saying they were doing a lot of singing and all that kind of stuff back there. What did you hear from back there?
I got it on my video camera, man. When George Bush came out, you know, they booed. I booed and I stopped booing so I could hear the crowd boo.
Uh-huh. Who was you booing?
George Bush. Okay, keep going.
That's not nice.
Right. So then I let the crowd boo, and you can hear it coming from behind me in all angles, and then right across from me, the hey, and it came in waves. It was from behind me, then it was on the side of me, and in front of me. I mean, it came from all over.
So, John, why was you booing? What brought the boo out of you? Yeah.
What brought the boo out of you?
What brought the boo out of you?
Hey, boo. Out of you.
Scooby-Dooby-Boo.
So what made you boo?
What made me boo was I've been alive for the past 8 years, you know, living
there
in this country,
go.
Paying bills, you know what I mean, and seeing everything that's been going wrong. I mean, it came out of nowhere. It came out of me, you know what I'm saying? It was an unconscious move, but I had to boo.
Every time,
now they had the Jumbotron, you know, y'all sat in the front, y'all had the good seats. Y'all didn't know they had Jumbotron so that everyone else
could
see.
We didn't, though.
They had Jumbotrons or Dumbotrons? I didn't get it.
Well, they had Buddy Lewis back. They projected all the things on his back.
Pre-shaving. But you had to read through the menu to see what Barack was saying. I'm sorry, that's, John.
Is that a titty?
Just as y'all were saying, every time Obama came on, Mr. President came on the screen.
There you go.
It was nothing but cheers, I mean, and people just screaming at the top of their lungs, and, you know, the guys were passing out these little flags, and everybody waved their flags, and you saw the first daughters or the first lady. Just a glimpse of them before, you know, the swearing in even began. But, you know, they just
did. You go to any of the parties or the balls?
He's with the kids.
Nah, man, I wasn't there for. Like I said, I brought my kids. You know, so I really wanted them to know that they were there for the inauguration. So we didn't really.
Oh.
It's such an exhausting.
So you didn't cheat on your wife that weekend? That was wonderful.
Now, John, let me ask you a question. What was the weirdest thing you saw Barack's face on?
The weirdest thing I saw his face.
Talk about paraphernalia.
On.
Yeah, as far as
his baby.
Diapers, condoms.
Nah, I ain't seen.
Now we saw
this one lady had. Nah, you know this one group had like a bright yellow, big hoodies, and they had Barack's face on that, and kind of like a multicolored like yellow and orange, and they had their names on the bottom. I was like, well, why would y'all put y'all name on the shirt instead of Obama's?
That's so they wouldn't get lost, because they had a lot of people with these loud colors with groups.
So they could find each other.
Yeah, with these with like loud powder blue beanies.
There's a lot of interesting
fashion. Well, thanks for the phone call, John. 877-2-106-106
is the number. Call in. Give us your point of view and where you were at the inauguration.
Yeah. All that shit Speedy said.
I just got an interesting, not interesting. It just goes back to our topic about Barack's blackness. Someone on MySpace just hit me up. B-Dub says, ask people who think Barack is something other than black, which water fountain he drank from the 60s and which restaurant he would have had to use.
What?
There you go.
Ask people that question Barack's blackness, which water fountain he drank from and which restaurant he'd have to use in the 60s. In other words, the people that are doubting his blackness.
Right.
Like, he wouldn't get any special treatment back then. Like, you know, he's black.
I think that's so stupid for people even to question his black. What is blackness? What does black enough mean?
I think
do the right thing. You know, the blessing about Barack Obama being president, that when he was a kid, the teacher told him you could be whatever you want to be. You can be a doctor, a lawyer, engineer. You can be the president.
What did your teacher tell you, John?
Get out.
You know what it is with the whole Barack?
You're wasting my time. Had a seat. Look,
what are you doing here in the fourth grade?
And my mother was a teacher. Said, go on home, boy. You ain't going.
It's like this. When somebody
what are you doing here in the fourth grade?
You're not going to make it, son. Get it in the back.
You ever notice when there's a suspect on the news, they always say African-American or black person. And if it's other than black, they don't even say the race. Mm-hmm. You know, it's just like our society. We got to change that. So it's like when someone does something bad, it's a black man. When someone does something good, it's like, well, he's not all the way black.
But we have to change it too. Yes, we got to stop saying it's a black. Or was he black? If he wasn't black, this wouldn't happen. The change have to come from within and from everyone, not just the other cultures who are not maybe black or whatever case may be. We got to stop accepting the black as an excuse or as an antidote of why we could and could not do what we did and did do. We have to take responsibility.
Right, as a what?
That was very.
Yeah, we have to take that
again. As an antifreeze? You said as an antifreeze.
I can't do it again.
That was very profound.
You know, Johnny Mac don't read. If the word came out, let it roll.
You got that Jesse Jackson syndrome. You half forgot the word. You said, fuck it, I'm going to roll with it.
Yeah, oh, yeah, and I'm going to cut your balls off. That's the Jesse Jackson syndrome.
You had a little Aretha Franklin moment, huh?
Now, speaking of that, y'all was there.
Yes.
Don't blame her. It was cold.
Speedy, I'm not about to go there, Speedy.
It was cold.
Speedy, you don't know where I'm about to go. I know you love big women, but I'm about to go somewhere.
He defended her like he has relations with her.
Like, damn. Like, you know, like, y'all got the
I
same
like
size
her spaghetti
titties.
Strap outfits.
Let me ask you this.
Because it was spaghetti.
What was the response? Pre-sauced. The poem. Can we talk about the poem?
That was trash.
The poem.
Wow.
The rhythm was off.
No, we're going to talk about the older dude because this is the funny shit that was there. So the older cat come up. We don't know he's praying.
Cap Calloway,
so
I thought it was.
So Claudia goes, what's with the wino? So I don't know if he was heads about. So I look around. I'm going, I said, Claudia, I think he's praying. She went, oops, my bad.
Then he started rapping in the prayer.
But the prayer was on the
track. If you're yellow, you're mellow.
Yeah, the prayer was on the
track. Brown can stick around.
It's from somewhere.
But we've met somebody from D.C. And he's from D.C. And he does the prayers all the time in D.C. And they were like, oh, he's been around for years and whatever. And Chloe was like, I didn't know. I thought
I don't want my preacher.
That was
to start
Reverend
rapping.
Joseph Lowry. He ain't gonna make it.
Yeah, I don't want him doing my funeral.
But we didn't know he's praying. And because we were having such a great time, and people kept looking at us like we were down.
Some white folks got mad because he said that white needs to embrace what's right.
It's true though,
and
they need to.
Hunkies are monkeys.
They were offended by that.
Wow.
Niggas are gold diggers. I was like, what the fuck is this dude doing?
But when he said the first one, that's when we came out to prayer mode. We was like, huh?
Crackers are slackers.
I was like, what the fuck?
Off in practical.
We got another phone call. This is
for what?
For Speedy, because Speedy met this dude in a hotel named Rob.
Oh,
to call
is
in.
That Rob?
Yeah, this is Rob. So Rob, Speedy said, give him the key back to his room and show light.
And send him the other three condoms back.
What's up, Rob?
What's going on, y'all?
Hey, Rob.
What's going on, Speedy's baby?
Yeah, what's up, Claudia? I see you caught the right plane, huh, Claudia?
That's right. No, actually, they put me off the plane. I didn't get to get on that second plane that early.
Oh, that's right. They kicked you off, and Speedy had to sleep in a chair, huh?
That's right.
Wow. How would you know that?
Robbie. Roberto.
Roberto.
After I was being hospitable, you know, because that's what I do, you know, he calls, he's like, man, I miss my flight. I thought required reading was for the radio.
He looked out for us.
But Rob looked out for us at the Sheraton Suites.
He looked out and he snuck in my room and put a bottle of wine in there. I didn't tell him because I quit drinking.
Yeah, good, good. You didn't drink this weekend. That's good. You know, it was cold outside of Ibiza that night, though.
Rob, you was trying to get some, wasn't you?
No, man, I'm married, man. My brother was, but he don't run a 4-4.
Rob, you don't want to mess with her, Rob.
You know me well.
Go get him, yeah. Claudia.
No, we already had a discussion. Yeah. It was really funny. Cause, no.
So Rob, tell us about your experience, Rob. Give me some good talk.
My experience was pretty much in the hotel the whole time. 14-hour days, making sure everybody was taken care of. We still had some complications here and there. But I was sitting on my couch when the speech happened and, you know, Bush got booed and Barack got praised. You know, you couldn't beat that. You know, I was with my brother and my mom. Couldn't spend it with, my Caucasian mom because I'm a Barack Jr.
He's half a honky.
He looks like Special Ed.
I'm half a honky, but when I walk down the street, the woman's going to clutch her purse just as tight as if I was full black, so...
Yeah, if you was a comedian, you could have nailed that. But
yeah.
You work at hotels.
Yeah. Don't turn on him after he gave us
a ride. No, he's a funny concierge.
This is my boy. If you ever go down to the Sheraton Suites in Alexandria, you go and say, hey, I need to talk to Rob because Rob going to take care of you. And you were the best, man. And he listens to the show all the time.
Well, what do you do at the hotel, Rob? What do you do?
He thought John Madden was one of the 10 kids.
I run the food and beverage department. I'm food and beverage director.
You was getting snacks? Oh, Lord.
That's
now, what
Speedy
is Speedy giving?
No, I like
took
care Speedy.
Speedy. Bigging him up.
He was the engineer of food and snacks. So Speedy took a liking to him.
You must have had a donut belt buckle on. And Speedy
attacked him.
Speedy would not stop hugging him.
This nigga was a gravy scientist.
Donut belt buckle.
Leave it all kind of extra snacks in the mini bar. How the hell is there a ham in the mini bar? Thank you, sir.
I want the Speedy Sweet next time.
Oh, I want the Speedy Sweet.
Speedy Sweet.
The Speedy Sweet comes with sweets.
S-W-E-E-T-S. The Speedy Sweet.
He said he had a donut.
No, but thank
hey,
you.
Man, oh, thanks for, hey, Rob, thanks thank for you, looking man. Out for Speedy and Claudia. We love Speedy and Claudia, man. And when we come to D.C., we're going to show you love. Make sure you stay in touch, man. Good looking out for Speedy and Claudia.
A 12-piece toolbox.
Get back to work, you peasant.
A 12-piece toolbox.
With biscuits.
Said they got a 12-pack toolbox.
Speedy was calling him. We didn't even need to ride. He just wanted some damn hook up to the wet vending machine.
That nigga had a fudge cow Speedy was sipping on. We got another phone call. We got Sydney from the ATL. What up, Sydney?
Show light.
Sydney.
It's Civi, actually.
What is your name?
I got one of those names. It's Civi. It's S-I-V-I.
Okay, Sydney.
I got S-Y-D-N-E-Y.
You can be creative as fuck with the names.
Don't worry, baby. We know what you mean.
Come on, Civia.
Come on, Cinnamon. What was going on out there?
Let's go, Cinnamon.
Come on, Centipede.
Survival.
Did you call her Centipede?
Come on, Sydney and Bernstein. What's happening?
It was actually a wonderful experience. I took my mom, and it just so happens that Inauguration Day was my dad's birthday, and he passed away. So it was kind of like a family thing. I'm 35. My mom's 72. So we have a huge age difference. So it was good to see it from her eyes, to see it from my eyes.
Mad you told her age.
No, my mom is fly. My mom is kicking it looking like 50 every day. So she's happy. I told her.
What you look like? What you look like?
I'm eternally 25, boo.
You said what?
I'm eternally 25.
So where were you standing at, Miss?
We were actually, we got there about 10:15, and we actually got behind, like, the first set of Jumbotrons, and in, like, 15 minutes, it was like I took a picture and nobody was there, and I turned around, and it was, like, people everywhere. It was bananas. And it was interesting, though, because even on the train, I rode the Orange Line, and we had to, like, push to get on the train, and it was like any other day, I would have been mad. People would have been cussing, but everybody was at, you know, really good place. I was, like, falling all over this guy, so I felt like I should introduce myself because I felt like, you know, we was kind of in an intimate situation.
You hussy.
Whore! Centipede.
I didn't mean to grab your balls.
You were inaugurating something there.
I didn't mean to grab your balls.
So you tried to cocoon somebody.
Civi now has the hibby.
Go ahead, Civi.
Did you go to any parties?
He was from Toronto. I didn't go anywhere. I was tired. I was supposed to go to the park. I was supposed to go to a ball, but after going to the inauguration, after kind of being trapped there because we thought we were being slick and trying to, like, scoot out early, and we got to the gate, and the National Guard and the police was like, yeah, good luck. We ain't open this gate till 5:30. So wow. I was like, but it's 12:30. Yeah. He's like, yeah, but we not open until 5:30. So
yeah.
By the time they opened the gate, it was like 1:10, 1:15, and everybody was leaving at the same time. So it kind of looked like March of the Penguins a little bit because we were herded off.
That's funny.
And it was like once you chose a street, you were stuck. Yeah. So we ended up basically walking like 4 or 5 miles because I didn't get on the train until I got to like M Street or something.
Yeah,
and I think we started at D.
Over there,
exactly.
That's where me and Claudia were. And then
references to food right now, yeah. Speedy. We just curious.
I want somebody that was there to call in and tell me about the parties, the loose women.
I came up.
The balls who had a ball.
Wait a minute, Speedy. You came up?
I was there.
Are you saying you had sex with someone out there?
Hey, let's move on.
Yes.
No, I'm asking. You did meet someone out there that was
you
really
a condom?
Nice.
Of course not.
I used the Barack
condom. Are you going to?
It's a Barack condom. Yes, we can.
Are you going to put that young
Speedy
lady
condoms
out there
have
like that?
A tip
no,
exit.
No, I didn't do anything.
She's a nice
What's lady.
She
was a Speedy nice condoms one. Have tip exits.
They got the child support exit.
No, she was cool.
Condoms have a doggy door.
So if you was out there, please call in.
877-2106-106.
I need those good stories. We got it. It was a beautiful, holy, and majestic. I got that.
You want the dirt.
I want to get, because somebody out there was giving it up. I want to hear, because there's some L.A. groupies went out there, and I was mad because I had to go to a party out here, and there was no groupies. And I was like.
You're back now, though.
Yeah, how was it watching it from here, though, John?
I wouldn't know, Speedy.
You didn't watch it at all?
I did.
I wasn't here either.
Okay.
All right. I don't want to speak on that. I'm not being sensitive. I enjoy the HBO on Monday.
Don't sell weed when you're 13.
You can go to stuff like this.
Believe in yourself when they say you can be the president. Nigga, I can be DUI class president. Nigga, I ain't going to make shit in my whole life.
Johnny Mac, I want you to change that. I think you're a lot better than you give yourself credit for.
I am. I am a great human being.
I know last year
you got low self-esteem.
Last year and the year before, we were on some we ain't shit type of shit. Maybe we should be on some we kind of out of shit.
No.
Yes.
Yeah. You know why?
I already quit drinking.
Yes, she did.
Right. You ran out of drinks. That's not quit drinks.
She got some brandy flavored Nylators over here.
I do have those. But I left a full bottle of champagne intact in my room. It hurt my heart.
Because you couldn't get on the plane.
That's true. But I didn't sip on anything.
That's great.
And that's beautiful, Claudia.
You did sip on something. What was his name?
No, she sucked on something.
Yeah, Johnny Mac, no more I ain't shit stuff.
Speedy. I never said I wasn't shit.
You just said it. Yes, I ain't going to be shit. I ain't shit. My skin ain't shit. My hair ain't mine.
It's about a bitch. Your career ain't shit.
We got the same career right now.
We both here.
Yeah, but difference, I ain't trying.
We can tell when you read the commercial.
Well, they gave it to a real actor. They didn't want you to read it.
Put in the game. Please, somebody put in a game where Johnny Mac was a stripper.
What? Oh, yeah.
Johnny Mac's episode of the game.
He was a stripper.
Yo, that's a stripper, all, John?
That's what he was reduced to.
Oh, on the Jimmy Fox show?
No, the game. Remember the game?
You told me you did a guest star role.
Oh, man, they played me, man.
You were the stripper,
wait a minute.
John?
You told me you were all excited going down the
game. I'm
going to
blast these motherfuckers right on out. You got a TV show, the game. They called me.
Specifically.
And you called me when they called
and
you.
And I'll go down there for 2 days. I was supposed to meet the white broad at the bar. I convinced her to have a drink and let's go dance. And then I was trying to seduce her to go into the bathroom
so
to get it cracked.
Down to your skivvies.
Nigga, they took all of that out and just had me dancing like Forrest Whitaker or something in this motherfucker.
It looked like a Maxi Priest bobblehead doll.
So he was really cousin it.
All you saw, all they did was have him from the back. I'm like, this is a team on this.
Nigga, I was so hurt. So shout out to the gang. I hope y'all went in D.C. because they went and showed it. Yo, we got to take a quick commercial break. We take a quick break. You want to go to Claudia first?
Oh, I got to read this shit again.
So we're not going to go to take a break. We're going to go to Claudia.
This show is on point.
Hey, before I read this, can I get a damn watch around this bitch?
Can I get a watch?
No, seriously.
We all gonna get watches, Claudia. It depends how good you read.
Acid watch. Can I get a watch?
Acid watch. Did you call him Albie Schuer?
She's talking about one of our producers have on
his watch.
It's called Stone Wash.
Stone Wash.
That nigga washed it with, he washed it with three rocks. That's what happened.
You know when you go
three crack rocks.
You see cement in the cement truck mixing.
So he went a whole 9 yards right now.
He looked like a turtle that slid down the street. It's all scuffed up.
You know how the screen gets fucked up when you see the ring? The ring.
You're trying to call him poltergeist?
So that's what you see right before the bitch comes out the well.
Well, she really climbed out a spilly belly button.
That wasn't funny.
I'm sorry. I take that back, Speedy. I'm going to do the fat jokes when I have my buddy Lewis.
So with that being said, can I get a watch?
Yeah, they got watches for everybody.
They got you.
Now,
it depends on how good you read this.
Oh, come on now.
You want the one with the bezels? You want the one with the 40-time clock on it?
I actually do.
Her watch only goes to 4.2.
And he has a 4.4, so lose my number, nigga. You didn't make the Pro Bowl.
You're a practice squad, nigga. Go ahead, Clark. Don't interrupt.
The holidays are here. Wait a minute. The holidays are over, and that means that Valentine's Day will be here before you know it, and most guys won't be ready. Audemars Piguet, the world's oldest luxury watchmaker, still in the hands of its founding family, will make this holiday timeless. Audemars Piguet invites you to enter and win his and hers Audemars Piguet watches this Valentine's Day on Sirius.com/AP. Not familiar with Audemars Piguet? AP is known for its daring achievements, record number of world's firsts, and celebrity loyalists. One lucky listener will win a pair of Audemars Piguet Royal Oak watches with a combined value of almost $25,000. His watch is a classic in stainless steel with its iconic octagonal bezel. Her Royal Oak has the added sparkle of 32 diamonds. Make this Valentine's Day one to remember. Enter today to win a pair of Audemars Piguet Royal Oak watches this Valentine's Day on Sirius.com/AP. No purchase necessary. Must be at least 18 and a resident of the lower 48 states or D.C. to enter. Entry deadline is February 12th, 2009. See official rules at Sirius.com/AP.
She said, is that the shirt you see when the bitch crawl out the window?
You know exactly what I'm talking about. Johnny's like, I hate you. You know, it's so funny. Me and you ain't went at it in years.
I would never go at it with Christmas.
I hate going at it with you.
I don't hate
it. It's like
it.
When Rocky and Apollo punch each other at the same time.
I think you should just go at Buddy Lewis.
Buddy's been
I'll never go
today.
At Buddy Lewis.
What's the matter, buddy?
Hey, nothing at all.
Your breast milk is leaking.
Got your period.
All of that. All of that.
Tampon string is showing.
That all of that. Polka dot.
All of that.
You thought that was a polka dot shirt. It's just wet spots, nigga.
All of that.
No, what's wrong with
Lewis? I think he's upset because he's sitting in Lewis's seat.
No, I'm actually.
But you know what's
good.
Funny, though? Buddy Lewis is a great actor.
I always say that.
That motherfucker.
Someone.
I always do that after I've been mean to him because I'm going to hit him with another shot.
Well, tell us, you're doing the movie Black Dynamite.
Yeah, that's why I wasn't at the inauguration. I was at Sundance Film Festival advancing my career while people were watching a person that already has one. So,
nigga, you was working on
No, I was at the Sundance Film Festival, the movie that...
Festival. Chris,
you were at the buffet.
Nigga, be a
yeah, whatever. I was there. And the movie Black Dynamite, which you can go see www.blackdynamite.com. Go see the trailer.
Trailer's all the chain.
Me, Chris Spencer, Kim Whitley,
star.
Sally Richardson, and Mike Jai White is the star. Arsenio Hall. Arsenio Hall, Byron Mims. There's a whole bunch of people in it. Great cast. Great
cast.
Yeah,
Buddy Lewis, I do
Michael
your prop.
J. White.
Greg Morris.
I do your prop.
Oh, you always do, Johnny. Yeah,
Buddy Lewis was a great actor, man. You've seen him in a gang of things, man. And make sure you go check him out.
I've seen him at the food court.
The Sundance Festival.
Be silent.
Festival. I said festival. And since you're going places, please.
Taco Bell.
The Bud Bowl is back in a big way this year, and we have some exciting things to fill you in on. First, Bud Light has a secret commercial that would not be aired on TV during the time of the game. This particular ad would only be available online. So check out BudBowl.com or the Bud Bowl Facebook page to learn more. You will not want to miss this because it will be talked about by everyone. Bud Light is also giving away a 46-inch sharp flat screen TV just in time of the game. Come with your own plug. To register, grab your cell and text Bud Bowl to Beers. 23377. between now and February the 1st. Don't miss your chance to watch the Cardinals and the Steelers battle out on a big screen courtesy of Bud Light. And all of the Bud Light ads will be available to view on BudBowl.com after the game. You will also be able to download and post a secret spot on your Facebook and MySpace. Bud Bowl. Grab a Bud Light. Make sure you watch. Hey, the Bud Bowl.
Can we do a commercial? You think they let us do a commercial?
That's the toilet bowl. But
they should have the,
hey, they
have
the
foxhole
bowl. That's the one. That's they be having the horses and shit. Remember them? The commercials? Hey, the Super Bowl commercials be off the chain.
They should have the foxhole in the commercial. But people.
Let's write it.
Figure it out. Yeah, we'll write it.
Yeah, let's write it, Speedy. Right. Yeah, just put the menu down and write something else.
and turn his back around.
Speaking of food, Speedy had a lot of, he sampled a lot of stuff in D.C. He had the Barack Obama chili.
It was off the chain.
This nigga was licking the bowl like a motherfucker.
Ben's Chili Bowl?
No.
Y'all go to Ben's?
What's the name of the place?
No, we didn't go there. What happened was at the hotel, they got the, I guess they have his.
His recipe from the internet.
It's on the internet, and they did, it was off the chain.
Was it spicy? Yeah.
A little bit, but it was
so
good.
You ate all the samples for everybody else. You just made it into one big bowl.
They ran out by the time I ordered.
Did it have half black beans, half white beans?
they had lima beans and kidney beans.
And the Barack beans.
And the kidney beans was mad at the lima.
We're going to take a quick break right quick. We come right back and play some music. Take a quick break. We'll be right back. Yo, we're back.
Yes, we are.
That's Jamie Foxx blaming on the alcohol.
Make sure.
If you out there and you ain't got it, you owe yourself the listening pleasure of going out and get Jamie Foxx's new CD. Trust me. There's some songs on there, man. There's some beautiful writing, some beautiful melody. Beautiful.
Sound. Okay.
Let me do this, Speedy. You're going to get fired for
from the nigga who wanted to fuck Eric Benet.
Yeah, it's the nigga that laid his head on Eric Benet's shoulders. Beautiful could be in my arsenal, too.
Nigga, we ain't forgot.
We ain't forgot you got weak, nigga.
Yeah, real quick, what happened again?
They got matching toe rings now. That's all I'm saying. That's all I'm saying. Magnetic matching toe rings.
Fuck all you niggas.
What happened was...
That was the problem. Suck something, punk. Hey, trying to separate his back pocket.
What happened was...
Eric Benet was here singing live.
Right.
And then he was about to leave, and then Speedy begged him to stay.
No,
but he said, baby, don't go.
Yeah, he said, don't go, baby.
I heard the nigga turned into Eric Belay.
Chris.
And so did Nasty Belay.
Chris. Speedy used his sexy voice that he uses on the intro.
No, he didn't.
I swear to God.
From South
he said,
Los
baby, don't go.
You know what?
Yes,
we don't have
sexy.
To go through this. New York, can we just pull that up?
Baby, don't go.
Can we just pull up that piece?
Yes, that'd be cool.
Run up on me, nigga, and say how I go for you. Bitch,
Speedy.
Speedy, I can run up on you and run away from you. You nigga, fat fuck.
Yeah, your reaction time ain't fast unless the dinner bell's ringing. Sorry, Speedy, I haven't had you in a long time. We cool.
I know the girl built like a swizzle stick.
And you was, like, you was.
That's why you're not drinking, because you in the drink.
She built like a Bud Light bottle.
Oh, I can't do that. I forgot. She
took
care of me.
Yeah, nigga.
She took care of me.
Nigga, don't make me.
It went bad.
Yeah, it went real bad for you, didn't it?
You had to loan him some money, Claudia.
If it weren't for Claudia,
I'd still be at the airport.
Nigga, didn't it go bad in Circuit City? Okay, then. I'm out of here.
Hey, Claudia. That's what Johnny Mac likes. I like to hear the bad shit that happened on your trip.
No, you don't.
We got all the positive shit
in it. We'll get to that later.
You keep making skinny jokes. I'm going to unleash it.
You're not skinny, Claudia.
Skinny.
Claudia, you're
scared.
Beautiful.
Why would you be offended?
If I move this pen, I couldn't see you.
If I move planet Earth, I could see you.
Damn, she calling you Pluto.
No, Pluto.
Yo, we got some special guests.
Hypodermic.
We got some special guests who's going to really. We got some special guests. We got some special guests, and we're going to let Porter. As these two niggas go at it again. Law and Hardy, before and never.
Well, we want to welcome Ms. Art in Miami the most from Thiz Entertainment, straight out of Vallejo.
Yeah.
Welcome.
Yeah.
They actually have been down with the late, great Mac Dre.
Yeah.
And they're also part of the movement, the hyphy movement that's big in the Bay Area, right? And it's national. Yeah. National. Step to the mic, you guys. How y'all doing?
Blessed.
You guys come up on the mic.
Yeah, we ain't that proud of a station.
My man was way back. He said, nigga.
You gotta
put the mic on your throat. Trust me.
I really usually don't have to. I mean, my voice really just usually show up.
I'm really Mike compatible.
I thought you was a Cookie Monster at first.
Hello!
Cookie!
Hello!
Did Ja Rule make a comeback?
I thought he was dead.
Right. No, so, Ja Rule lived, but his career died.
That's right.
So, Ms. Art in Miami, tell us what your relation to Mac Dre is and Thiz Entertainment and this whole hyphy movement.
Okay, Dre was like my god brother. Me, Dre, and Kilo Kurt own the company.
Mm-hmm. Who?
Kilo Kurt. That's the youngin'. Another one didn't show up. Him, Jay Diggs, Coolio, get all
you
of them.
You Kilo Kurt.
I got the names for you.
Nine out of ten, you and Jay.
Hey, look.
All I'm saying, Kilo Kurt had grams.
1,000 of them. A million of them.
So he weighed himself here.
Yeah. He couldn't,
so basically, like, those are the guys, the Codys, the guys that you see in American Gangster, the story on.
Gotcha. Okay, yeah.
Okay, those are my juniors. Like, you know, I raised them kids. Like, I'm the guy from the neighborhood. I ain't ever been to jail. You know what
impossible.
I mean? For real. G-O-D. I'm God's gangster, for real. God got my back. So
you ain't never been to jail.
Hold
in
on.
Life.
Miami.
You don't know what
Miami
it means.
Miami the most.
Man, look.
You don't know what it means, but salt down.
What happened on the way up here?
You don't know. You don't
Miami
know salt
the
down.
Most.
15 minutes, sunrise and shine.
You ain't never been Fishbook.
Hey, check this out. I'm a grown man, man.
What?
Grown man.
Hey, it's a comedy station.
I don't know what it is.
Yeah, because he pulled a gun out.
I really don't know what it is.
But he got a gun.
Johnny Mac, don't get off. Wait up in this bitch.
Okay, so Miami. Could you just tell for
I ain't never been to jail, nigga.
For those who don't know
like
who Mac Dre is and what the hyphy movement is, if you could just explain that.
The hyphy movement is something that they tried
you
to
get near the
make
mic.
Up. The hyphy movement don't got nothing to really do with Mac Dre.
No, okay. Really.
You know what I mean? That's something that they came with afterwards to try to imitate Dre.
Oh, okay.
You know, Dre always was hype. Get hype. Keith the Sneak was the one start saying hype first.
Who?
Yeah. Keith the Sneak, the first one who said hype.
Right. Got name.
Dre said get hype. You know what I mean?
Right. Keith the
so
Sneak.
That hype movement was just some reason for them niggas to copy Dre's pattern of what Dre was doing.
Well, how about looking at it as a point of continuing his legacy and not so much biting?
Who Keith?
Because they would. I mean, if there's continuing his legacy, they would have said that.
Ooh. I've heard.
That's easy. Yeah.
I mean, anybody that's shout Mac Dre out.
Yeah, if they are artists, if we paying them, they on the label,
right.
Putting their projects out. But if
you got gold grill top.
If their projects ain't coming out, it's different. Them diamonds. If you know, you know. It's
different. You got silver and gold. Okay. Go ahead, old Pimp.
Okay, so we,
that nigga's real.
So we know that
Kurt Franklin designed that.
Mac Dre is was a huge underground artist in the Bay Area.
Right.
He's put out over 30 albums. Is
and
it?
I'm looking at all the albums on the back of this
now,
box. That's all.
He put out over 30 albums. What period of time did it take him to release that many albums? Because he had a short,
of
a short rap career, right?
I mean, like from 98 to like the time he left, he did like 20-something albums.
Okay.
Because like when he first left, he only had like 2 albums
mm-hmm.
when he went to the prison.
Right.
So after that, all the other albums was created.
And some of you might be familiar with Mac Dre's story. They were just featured on American Gangster on BET, the Romper Room Gang.
The Romper Room Gang, yeah.
Right, and they were known for robbing banks around the Bay Area. And so how did he transition out of that lifestyle into
the
rap game?
From for the 30
God. Because, like, that lifestyle is, that's just lifestyle. I mean, I really can't speak on that lifestyle. Mm-hmm. Them niggas is gangsters, man. Yeah, I don't know. I can't speak on that. I wouldn't even imagine.
So, no, I'm saying how did Dre...
Dre never did that. That was the homies doing that shit. Dre mm-hmm. just didn't run his mouth. Dre mm-hmm. wasn't a bank robber, you know
right,
what I mean?
Right,
Dre the Dre the comedian. He come around when niggas want to go do something and laugh, and he give them some money and make them don't do it. They call Dre on the day and hand no money. He say, I'm going to ride with you, niggas.
Are you guys on any of these albums?
Yeah, I'm on. Damn, they're all of them.
Shit, 30 of them?
Okay.
You know, they called Dre on a day that he wasn't doing nothing, you know. And, like, with that shit, it's like anything else. Like, if you gamble in the arena, if I ain't with you, when you hit, you ain't give me no money.
That sound like Johnny Mac.
Yeah, that's how it goes with me.
You know,
if you with me and you ain't looking, you ain't getting no money.
You feel me? So a nigga was trying to be looking to get some money, basically. But he wasn't. Man.
And you guys are going to do a movie about him, right?
Yeah.
That's dope.
That's what I'm saying. We're trying to get Michael Epps to play the character.
He kind of looks like Mike Epps, too.
Yeah, he do. He do.
Looks like Mike Epps.
So what do you feel is so unique about Mac Dre and why he has such a huge following in the Bay Area? He was so influential in terms of style and even though...
Multicultural.
Although we've heard Keek the Sneak in
because
E-40,
he's multicultural. Everybody in multicultural. White friends, black friends, Mexican friends, Chinese friends. He dinners with Indians, Arabs, everything. Everybody come in and out that... About your house, you know what
he's
I mean.
He's diverse.
Certain
diverse
people
group of friends.
Is segregated. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
We didn't went out of state, and me and Dre is the reason these niggas function with Mexicans and Chinese. They didn't even deal with people like that. Like when we went to Kansas City the first time,
these black people didn't have no Mexican friends and stuff. But these only people came to see us. So I'm like, man, y'all don't know them. I'm introducing people, and now they intermingling. You understand what I'm saying?
Right.
Now, how can you, if somebody wanted to get an album, wanted to start listening to it, do they have to go online? Can you go to stores? How do
you
go about
it? Yeah, the best way to go is rapbay.com.
Rapbay.com.
The Urban Life, yeah.
What do you feel Mac Dre's contribution to Bay Area rap is?
Man, that's heavy. He ain't finished yet. It ain't over. He's still contributing.
I love your answers.
Because
still
I know.
Contributing, you know what I mean?
I want my man to speak up.
I don't want to.
But just watching, like, the American.
Still contributing.
That nigga said, that's heavy. My that man said, sense. Really?
Just by watching American Gangster,
I see the microphone.
I could see his style with my the stunner turn. Shades, right. The right. Whole outlandish look.
Obama.
Was influential in terms of style in the Bay Area.
Definitely, definitely.
And how did he pass?
Because, like, Obama's hippies, a... man. We hippies. We recycled hippies. We ain't nothing but hippies, man.
Well, I know that's Berkeley, the whole
yeah, that's all we are.
Black
hippies, man.
how did he pass away, for those who don't know?
He was shot in Kansas City, Missouri, sleeping in a van. Mm-hmm. A van that we never traveled in. We've been out there in limos all week. And Dre happened to go somewhere. We in the room, a nigga in the room sleep. He got a car that we never been in, went to go get something. And the motherfuckers shoot up the van.
What happened? Who?
So they say Fat Tone killed Dre. Fat Tone didn't kill Dre. Whoever killed Dre didn't know Dre was in that car. I was in Kansas City, and nigga, I ain't never spoke.
Right.
So all yeah. The other shit that people saying is fake.
Okay, so a lot of people would have
Dre
to have seen.
Know Dre was in there.
So you believe it was a random act of violence?
I know it was. I'm here.
It's tragic.
It was there. Like I'm a firm believer that van is from out there. So that's some shit them people had going.
Okay, it may have been a random.
Seen that.
It may have been a random shooting, but Fat Tone was consequently alleging was killed as a result of Mac Dre's death, right?
That's what I heard. That's why I'm saying whoever did that is wrong. Whoever did that is wrong. I know Fat Tone personally. We was cool. I mean, that nigga ain't did that to Dre.
Yeah. So someone who thought he had something to do with Mac Dre's murder and murdered him.
I don't know. I don't know them people.
What was Mac Dre's biggest selling song?
Album number 7.
Yeah. Nah. Nah, he damn near right, though. Hey, he almost right. Stupid doodle dumb.
Stupid.
How does that one go?
Stupid doodle dumb.
Yeah, nigga. Dude, we have some music. Yeah. We actually have nigga? Some music
shit.
With us.
Recognize, bitch.
Yeah. We have
stupid.
Since 94, since 84, that's on the Ronald Reagan soundtrack. That's what that bobblehead's from.
We actually have Ronald some music. Drake. You brought us some music today.
Yeah, that's what the bobblehead's from.
So what are we going to listen to?
We're going
to
play Since 84.
Yeah, that's,
so, that's the name of the song?
From the yeah. Ronald Reagan project.
And that's the latest project that's
nah,
out?
Nope,
no.
No.
Okay.
So let me listen to Mac Dre.
What it is.
Rest in peace.
84.
Biz in peace.
Yo, that was Mac Dre since 84. Hot.
Off that Ronald Reagan soundtrack.
Yeah, that was crazy. That was hot.
And I just want to say big ups to my manager, Stretch, that brought me out here. His name
Lil Youngster?
Lonnie, yeah.
He's 13.
His sister work here. Yeah, that's my manager.
LB3.
He's like 13.
I know he ain't made the mistakes that I made, so there I can trust
go.
In
there
him.
There you go.
And if you're just tuning in, we're in the house with Miami the Most and Mizart from Thiz Entertainment. They worked with the late Mac Dre. And yeah. Where could people get Mac
get
Dre
it, like,
albums?
You can order from City Hall Records. That's out of the Bay Area. You can order from rapbay.com. Uh-huh. You can go to thizworld.net. You can go to Thiz Online. And then, like, the basic stores that they order from, I guess, the mm-hmm. Rasputins and all
iTunes.
Of those stuff. Yeah, all the iTunes.
But people that are okay. Familiar, you rap too? Do you rap?
I entertain.
Okay. How'd you get the watch? Because I was
peeping
the watches. Do you have insurance on it? I do have a grudge.
I got the watch from Kilo.
How's your 40 time?
I mean, I'm really. It depends on the situation.
You run into Claudia.
If you're in a combine.
Well, we want to thank you guys.
I'm running back at you if you're chasing me.
Anything you guys want to add before we wrap up?
I mean, I just wanted you guys to know that Thiz is working on a gospel rap album. Like, all the gangster rappers don't give me a song about God. I don't care what they talking about. That's, like, the biggest thing we got coming up.
Wow.
So, like, that's what we're really focusing on.
So, making God
and I'm
going
to call Wrap It Up.
Jesus, okay. Love thank you, mother. You,
Speedy, wrap that dick up. No more illegitimates.
Wow.
You can play that with your fat women.
But you I love you guys, and I appreciate
women
you.
Got to lose one battery.
No problem.
Claudia, how about we drink to it?
Hey, after I heard what y'all did to Big Tigger, I was really looking at y'all to really get on me. I've only seen this show one time. Y'all was talking about Tigger. I said,
well, we're being nice because we
got to get on this
show. We're being nice because we don't know if you got the gun. We're a little bit scared. We don't have no metal detectors.
Nah, y'all were. I don't think y'all was lying.
No, I wasn't lying.
I want to.
Soon as you leave, though,
I want to say thank you.
Mac, I know where you at, baby.
Soon as you get outside this radio frequency,
I know where the Mac man is.
I want to. You don't have serious, dude.
I got jokes, nigga.
I want to thank you guys.
Yeah, my real name is Freddie Jackson. Trust me.
You killed me, man.
I want to thank you guys for coming by. I want to send a big shout out to everybody in Vallejo. My mom lives out there. My brother Tasha, who's listening
right now.
Whoa. No, he doesn't.
To all my baby mamas. We made it. We've got this old plan.
You ain't got more baby mamas than Speedy.
How many baby mamas you have?
Hey, I'm doing a fundraiser for Vallejo because they bankrupt. We're trying to gather some money.
Yeah, really? Wait. So before you go, let me ask you.
Y'all want to put some money in this hat for me so I can
Let me ask you about that.
Hey, I'm from North Richmond. They bankrupt too.
One more question. Is it true that Vallejo does not have a police department?
Hell no.
All we got is three police.
Because they said the city went bankrupt and there's no
Go run a red light.
Man, they just tasered my nephew last night.
Okay. Thanks, you guys.
So we'll ask your nephew if they got police.
They just tased him last night.
It was some niggas in uniform.
Yeah, he had a shocking experience, let me tell you.
It was electrifying.
I stood up.
Oh, shit.
Thanks, you guys. Okay. All the best, too.
Hey,
thank you.
Thank you so much.
But soon as you get outside this motherfucking building.
Say it right now.
Say it right.
No,
I ain't gonna say shit.
We don't really
need it. I got you. We ain't got no security.
If that nigga downstairs gonna write your name down, that's all we got going.
We got a retired cop with a slingshot. That's it. Okay.
Hey, once again, you'd like to thank you guys for coming out, man. The Mac Dre. If you got a chance to go out there, pick up that download and everything else, please make sure you support that. These some cool brothers. I appreciate that the brother never been to jail. Yeah. Look how nice that been to him right now.
See how big that jacket is.
All right. Thank you, fellas.
All right, Blake.
All right.
Hey, we appreciate y'all.
I'm going to trade it in. I'm going to trade everything I got to trade in.
Nigga, that leather jacket is so old, nigga.
Oh, that was a couch.
Your head old, too. It's everything.
His jokes ain't really funny, John.
Like, skin niggas out.
That's coming from a nigga that looked like Dougie Fresh. Look, Dougie ain't so fresh.
Wait a minute. Let me see the door.
Yeah, wait till the door closed. Hold it.
Hold on.
This nigga was older than bootleg pregnancy
tests. Hold on, John.
Those are some great brothers.
Yeah.
And nigga, your leather jacket still bleeding on the inside.
Where is security?
See, John?
What's in my heart is jokes. Watch this thing about your shoulders, nigga. Like somebody put two baby hangers together, nigga.
It's all jokes. It's a comedy.
What it look like, that's what it is. You won't know till you see.
Hey, Chris Thomas said, bring his lips back.
run it back one more time.
Okay. Now, it's a comedy station, fellas. Yeah. No, for real.
Where is security?
I don't know if he is. I see the look in his eye.
That nigga looks serious.
I'm
having fun. This is lovely.
Hey, God.
Yeah, but we know the weight ain't on your shoulders. I can tell you that.
This nigga scaring me.
Shoulder blades. We're going to need you to keep it moving.
Man, I'm mic stuck, man. Help me a little bit, big dog.
Okay.
Hey, you should always, that was funny. Yo, go. Give it up for Ms. Ark.
You should always wear the Pee-wee shoulder pads wherever you go, nigga.
Yo, man, don't worry. But get out of here, man. Really. Get out of here.
Yeah.
Take little George Foreman with you.
Are you trying to say grill?
No, like a baby George, he's still in the lobby.
But out the grill.
Let me just stay by.
It's the funniest show.
Niggas are sitting on booster seats.
Hold on, still in the lobby. Let me read my commercial.
Okay. Look right there.
Thug rappers in booster seats.
That nigga had the shoulder blade of Keisha Cole's. You started it, Ms. Rock. I was nice to you. You started it.
That ain't his name, nigga.
This nigga got a size 1 Timberland boot.
This nigga wearing a 6 Tyler t-shirt right now, nigga.
The nigga was looking at us behind the fish tank. No. We said
I'm saying it when you leave. Fuck you.
When he was behind the
buy the fish tank. Nigga look like
hey,
that.
He gonna come back and get us with a little pistol.
Come on. That nigga like a blackened catfish.
Behind, that nigga look like a Jack Dempsey.
Come on now.
That nigga like a 5'8".
I thought he was black coral.
I thought he was an eel.
Oh, it was a catfish. I didn't know they survived in fresh water. Okay, let's go. All right, ready?
Leave Beetlejuice alone.
Without the sweater. Okay, let's get
started. Beetlejuice!
Come on, it's Starry. Hey, he gonna come back and shoot all of us. Seriously.
We got security. He's a cop.
We only got one. They got more pistols on them.
Them niggas ain't got cases.
Okay. Sophus and Paul didn't bring us.
The one day
I know that nigga Chapstick Bill is a motherfucker. That nigga lives as dry as a cotton field, nigga. That nigga start talking, he's gonna start a fire, nigga. All that fucking sparks.
Like the fish that put their lips on the tank.
The fish that saved Pittsburgh, nigga.
The fish lips.
Never laugh from my back.
Oh, my okay. God. All right, we gotta stop. Go ahead.
Okay, Claudia. We gotta stop, Claudia. You see, you get us all off track, man. We gotta. Chris Prince is on your phone.
I don't care.
Are these niggas still staring at us behind the coral? Okay.
They waiting to be fed. They need a little fish food.
How you in water and still chapped?
Ah.
All right. The holidays are over.
Okay.
We in break. Yeah. We in break. We in break.
Oh.
Y'all can't get mad. Nobody mad. We on time. Okay, well, nigga, we doing the joke.
Did they cut us down the jokes?
It was funny to us.
We all?
Shit.
We off there?
We not.
We
on air. Go ahead, Claudia.
All right.
They just said we was going to break.
No, New York just said we on air.
Okay, the holidays are over, and that means that Valentine's Day will be here before you know it, and most guys won't be ready. Audemars Piguet, the world's oldest luxury watchmaker, still in the hands of his founding family, will make this holiday time. Niggas, pipe down. Audemars Piguet invites you to enter and win his and hers Audemars Piguet watches this Valentine's Day on series.com/AP. Not familiar with Audemars Piguet? AP is known for its daring achievements, record number of firsts, and celebrity loyalties. One lucky listener will win a pair of Audemars Piguet Royal Oak watches with a combined value of almost $25,000. His watch is a classic in stainless steel with its iconic octagonal bezel. Her Royal Oak has the added sparkle of 32 diamonds. Make this Valentine's Day one to remember. Enter today to win a pair of Audemars Piguet Royal Oak watches this Valentine's Day on Sirius.com/AP. No purchase necessary. Must be at least 18 and a resident of the lower 48 states or D.C. to enter. Entry deadline is February 12th, 2009. See official rules at Sirius.com/AP.
Yo, we back.
Y'all niggas, can we read the commercials? Can everybody shut the fuck up for like 30 seconds?
Seriously.
Like, that's very unprofessional. That's a sponsor. I'm just saying we should just respect.
You're absolutely right.
We should respect the sponsors. Speed.
No, I did.
Like, when
I
you order in your fucking taco sandwiches and shit and Big Macs, we shut up so you can get your order right. So let's just get
some taco sandwiches. I hate getting my order wrong.
Huh? Yeah,
taco sandwiches.
Well, yeah, shit. Taco. It's whatever, Buddy Lewis. The one thing
it's Foxo Radio.
Oh my God.
Johnny
Tacos
Max
and
house.
Sandwiches. How about that?
Shoulder blades and all of his. 877-2106-106 is the number. I guess we should go to the Poetess Report. Put you on the spot right there.
I wish Poetess? People could see what they look like, though.
Hey, it was hysterical.
It really was. If they could see what they look like, it would make it all the more funny.
Nigga, leather jacket.
I've never laughed from my back.
I've never seen a cape with buttons on it in my life.
On the sleeve. Nigga had a bowling jacket on.
Okay. Had the skin of a Hawaiian hotspot. Volcanoes right. And shit.
All right, couple things going on in the Poetess Report. Daz Dillinger of the Dogtown is teaming up with his mom to do a gospel album and video.
Is she a pastor?
She's a pastor.
Oh, okay.
She's
the
doctor.
Mom is a pastor?
Yes, his mom is a pastor. You know what?
She's
a few of the guys that are down with that are in the dog pound. They come from a strict religious church background.
What church is this?
Yeah,
the Church of One Bullet.
Church the Pistol.
We gonna get an A selection from Daz Dillinger. What kind of bullshit is that?
They were raised up in the church.
I bet you guys pay your tithes at that church.
Is an evangelist who
all right, everybody. Pay your time.
If y'all motherfuckers want me to do the Poetess Report, let me get through this shit. Whoa. Damn.
Yeah, you need to smoke more weed.
Wow.
Every day.
It worked.
All right, go ahead, Clark.
It worked.
Just calm down, nigga.
Okay.
Go ahead, Tasha.
That's the brother, Tasha.
Oh, my bad. They look alike.
Anyway, his mom signed to a gospel label. They're doing a song.
called I'm Good, and they're also going to be doing a video for that as well. And it's to kick off a music program for underserved inner city kids. So
that's a beautiful
doing thing. Good things, is doing good things.
Is there a second part to the song title, like I'm Good with a Pistol? Or
I'm Good in Jail.
I'm Good with a Sack of Weed.
I don't need that no
my books, your books.
Well,
this,
also,
this weed's from heaven.
Coming what out on Parole Records.
Also in the
I See God in the Smoke.
Don't let Holy Ghost Smoke. It's called Don't Let Suge Knight.
Also in the Poetess Report, Kimora Lee Simmons, the ex-wife of Russell Simmons.
That's funny.
I'm listening, Poetess.
Is expecting a baby with Digimon Hansu.
Jaimin Hansu.
They're expecting their first child.
And last night on Chelsea Lately, she said, I didn't know two dudes could have a baby.
Wow.
That's a Chelsea Lately. A white lady, Chelsea Lately, took a shot at Kimora.
Saying that she looks like a dude.
Kimora's fine.
Yeah, she is handsome.
She got a nice strong
double. And you know what? And she's potentially a big girl, too.
Yeah, she is a big girl.
I've seen her with some weight on.
Yeah.
So she already has two kids by Russell.
Baby Fatastod.
And this is Digimon's first child.
Are you calling it?
It's not Digimon.
It's German.
It's Dijon.
You don't pronounce it. It's Dijon.
Baby Fatastod.
It's Dijon.
Same way you spell Tashe.
Dijon.
His first word is going to be, give it us free.
Give us baby fat.
Free Happy Meals.
All right. Last but not least. For all the ladies,
please do the song.
D'Angelo is making a comeback.
For what?
But he ain't doing videos.
Claudia was in his first video.
The very first video I ever did was me.
You mean the one when he was naked?
No, I didn't do that one. That was you that was fluffing the dick.
And you tucked his balls in.
My first video, I was in L.A. and I got approached. They said, you want to do a D'Angelo video? And it was when he was fat, though.
Which song?
Me and Those Dreaming Eyes of Mine. It was actually a nice
He wasn't fat then.
No, he was like, he was a little fluffy.
Well, they say that he's coming back and he's bringing Prince on board along with CeeLo to help him complete.
CeeLo. To make him look thinner.
To help with his
taller. Wait, wait, is D'Angelo fat now?
According to this report, he looks good. So maybe he lost weight because he got up to, 300 pounds?
What?
Or 200 he looked like pounds?
CeeLo. No, that was Andy Stone.
Nigga!
That's
what baby.
Oh, shit! That's his baby's mother, though.
It is his baby's mama. But D'Angelo did get big. He got huge. He got huge. And he hasn't released an album since his Voodoo album in 2000. So he's coming back, and Rafael Sadiq and a bunch of other people.
He looked like Andy Stone.
I thought they were going to come back with guns. They came back with gifts. Thank you so much.
Thank you, brother.
Thanks, man.
Thank you so much. Oh, I get a doll. Thank you.
Where's my bobblehead? Wait a minute.
300. How you know he was 300 pounds?
He was pretty heavy.
He's
so
only 5'6", so.
So he's planning a
the right there in front of you.
He's planning his first major tour as well here in the United States and in Europe. So look out for D'Angelo, who will be dropping an album.
Is he
going
to remake Brown Sugar to Brown Sugar
Cupcakes? Brown Sugar Diabetes.
Well, you know he's been
Brown Sugar Daddies.
You know he's been having legal troubles, drug troubles,
right.
And he was recently in a car accident. So he's coming back from all that.
Well, no, it wasn't recently.
It wasn't recently, but he was in a car
accident. They stole his car.
He was so talented. He was saying.
Yeah, he
that
album
was
they found his car with a D'Angelo Lojack.
Chris, do the song.
Oh, he wants more. He wants more.
Chris, do the song.
Miz
Art
wants more.
Don't do it, Miz.
No, Miz Art, we got in trouble.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do the song
again,
Chris.
You here.
Chris, please go. How's the song go, Chris?
It's joking.
How's the song go, Chris?
No, man, just go.
Do the fucking song.
Do this.
New bobblehead. Who wants some head?
Oh, that's Johnny Mac, yeah.
Johnny Mac, nothing.
The new Johnny Mac bobblehead coming out.
Thank you, man. Yo, young dude, peace.
Officer
13.
Paul, you're not doing your job.
Yeah, so
keep the riffraff out.
So what about the? I heard Ellen DeGeneres got Aretha Franklin's hat. What was that all about?
Yeah, she wore the hat after the
the actual hat?
No, not the actual hat.
She
made a
like
joke
it.
Out of it. She was saying that the guy who made the hat for her told her it was the only hat like that in the world, and then Aretha wears it.
That hat was ridiculous.
Really?
I thought it was kind of dope.
You liked it?
I thought it was appropriate.
It looked like a silver beanie.
She looks dope, man.
She looked like she took the aluminum foil off her leftovers from the food and made a hat out of it. Instead of making a swan, she made a hat.
I wanted to add one other note that this whole Barack thing is really changing the landscape of hip hop. And I've heard that MTV is changing their format to cater more to the Barack generation. And also Source Magazine is pulling out all its booty ads.
I'm not buying
Source. All the porno ads.
I'm not buying it.
All the booty shit in Source is done.
Listen, you guys should have some pride in how they portray the black women.
No,
that's good that they don't
like
have something.
I like ass on the black sister.
So if you're a beautiful black woman trying to get your
you
mommy
don't have an ass,
and you
like
got a great body, what you supposed to do?
No, they said they're pulling the
all you bitches ain't going to be Maya Angelou. Show your ass. And you got... Because it's not wrong for you to take away my talent. I happen to be funny. So because I'm funny, am I cooning?
But that's not a talent, having a big ass.
It is
a
talent.
It's not a talent.
It's a talent.
It's
when you don't have it.
It's a physical attribute. That's
you must
not
cultivate
a talent.
That ass.
So are you mad because you don't
put some...
I got enough ass, nigga.
You do got enough ass.
I do. I'm just fine.
Why
you
gotta be
with
a nigga? I thought
you you did all that shit about Barack and you said nigga.
Do not attack me, Circuit City. All right?
Okay.
That's all I'm going to say.
We got to know what happened in Circuit City.
Okay, drink.
You bought us some gadgets?
What happened in Circuit City?
His credit card didn't work. Yeah, I take 4 TVs, 3 iPods, and some electric stitching cords. I'm sorry, Mr. Speedy. Your credit card doesn't work.
This nigga knew we only had $17 left in his car. Going to order $48 worth of shit.
Electric stitching cords.
Electric stitching cords.
Let me get a t-shirt.
What happened in Circuit City?
And some batteries.
Nothing.
That's exactly what happened.
Something happened.
You paid for it, Claudia. We've all had our credit cards not work. That's not funny.
You've had a lot of cards didn't work.
It's all good.
Credit cards.
So whatever. I don't think.
I mean, I am a Barack supporter, and I truly love the whatever. But you can't stop the next cat from doing their thing.
I'm not for.
I mean, we all ain't gonna be politicians. I'm not saying that black women should exploit their body, but it's that black woman's choice to do what she wants to do with her body. So Source Magazine make a living off of that.
Well, you know what? No, the thing is, Source Magazine is a publication for young readers, and they don't need to be seeing all that shit in Source.
Why not?
Sex sales.
They can buy play. If
but
y'all want to see some
girl,
ass, buy
about,
some black tail or the other
but
little
what about
black.
The girl that wants to do that? You guys make it seem
that's
like
what I'm
it's something wrong because a woman has a body
listen,
that looks like
amen.
That. No, because usually, hold on, it's usually the woman that don't have the body that hates the woman that does have
that's
the body.
No, you know what? Women
that's not
that,
hating.
Women
hating.
That show their bodies off like that, do you guys?
Yes.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
Let me ask my question.
Speedy, are any of your kids
do you
moms
show them the same level
of
respect
no,
as
Austin,
you do?
But when I close my eyes.
They do.
Listen, to the guys here that have daughters, think of, you got to start thinking about.
I have a daughter.
It's my daughter's choice.
But if she has.
It's my daughter's choice.
But listen, it's the magazine's choice to take it out. If they want to go. They're just saying the Source decided not to put ass
and
in the magazine.
And I decided not to buy it.
I'm not going
to
buy Source.
Listen,
I'm going to buy Source.
You guys, listen. It's the little tiny bullshit ads in the very back of the magazine that you probably never look at anyways. It's little bootleg ads.
First of all, I start from the back.
We don't see them because they're usually stuck together.
Listen, I like the fact that some of these.
Claudia, I see you on Smooth. What are you talking about?
Yes, and I was styled. It was a nice fashion shoot.
No, you
was. Yes, it was.
You had a drink
was,
in your hand.
It was.
I did not have a drink in my hand.
It was. You had, on the cover, you had on a red bikini.
I did.
So ovaries.
You don't know what ovaries means, buddy Lewis. You never been around them.
He means okaries.
Don't be fooled.
He thought okra.
But Claudia, you did an episode. I don't know what you call it.
Okay, listen.
A photo shoot.
There is a difference between a modeling shoot where it's like you have nice clothes on, it's done in a tasteful way, than a booty ad where it's just a girl.
So
wait
buff,
a minute, let me finish. Let me finish. Let me finish, nigga. Like you finish your plate, let me finish what I'm saying.
I'll let you finish your Long Island. Go ahead.
When these girls are just facing the back and all you see is a thong up their ass, you don't even really even see
what's
their faces.
What's wrong with that?
It's objectifying women. That's all
no,
it is.
Well, what are you,
okay,
what
whatever,
do you want to do?
Whatever,
there's
nigga.
Nothing
you know
wrong
what?
With it, but when it's in a magazine viewed by kids, then there's some sort of issue.
Put it in the appropriate magazine.
Put a lock on
it. Put it in a Smooth magazine where you know that's what you're going to get. Put it in a King magazine. But don't
Source
put,
is a hip-hop magazine. They're supposed to focus on the music, the culture, fuck not fucking
music. And the
hoes
in the video.
And the hoes in the video. That's why they put them in, because the hotter your video is, the more your song's going to sell.
Yes.
You start doing videos with all niggas and see what happens.
It's not about not having guys in there. It's
niggas
just
gonna
about
be able to buy a
so the stuff that Buffy do, if you're trying to say that that's not creative?
Go shoot I Got Bros creative? In different areas.
Yeah,
clothes.
I Got Bros. See how popular your goddamn album is.
So, but answer the question, ladies. I'm asking the question. The Buffy the Body You mean to tell me those are not professional shots? Those are booty shots.
Listen,
all of them.
You're not. Just ask a question. You're not understanding what the ads are. They're not.
I'm just asking a question.
Have you seen what the ads are?
I'm asking you about.
Can you tell me
body.
With you guys? Is there a difference between sexy and slutty?
No.
Yeah.
Of course there is.
Yep.
But the stuff on that
so
they have wasn't
be
slutty.
Sexy in the magazine, but sometimes
slutty.
It's borderline slutty.
But you guys say they slutty. We never say
the
we
back
never
ads that. Of the magazines are not like the
slutty
ads where they feature
Superhead.
A Buffy or a Melissa
slutty.
Ford. They're totally different. Trust me. The back ads are where they have the fucking Viagra ads. Come on, buddy.
Slutty
and
Superhead.
And you know what I'm talking
I don't
about.
Need it.
Halle
Berry. But how else you gonna sell Viagra
Halle
if you don't show no ass?
A picture of Lou Ferrigno with this bottle.
It's the little measly ads.
It worked for me.
Wait, Buddy had an analogy.
I was gonna say it's the difference between Halle Berry in the movie with Billy Bob and Superhead. That's the difference. We like seeing nasty.
I do.
Halle Berry getting her little stuff tore up. That was
which I didn't think she should have got an Oscar for that.
Hey, I did.
I do.
I did not think she should have got an Oscar.
Whatever
for,
she won, because she should have won.
All the other stuff she did
whatever
was
she,
way better acting wise than that.
Catwoman. Get
then
out
she
of
let
here.
The white dude hit it from behind, and they gave
Catwoman.
Oscar.
Stop it. No, it wasn't the sex.
Dorothy
Dandridge.
It had to be.
Whatever. But what other movie did she got an Oscar for?
When she portrayed
Dorothy Dandridge.
Dorothy Dandridge.
And speaking of
so what.
Speaking of the Oscars,
you no
want
Oscar
to congratulate
one at a
time.
Cable movie.
You guys are all talking over each other. It's not going to be good.
Okay,
speaking of the Oscars, we want to congratulate Taraji. She
right.
got
yeah.
nominated
she
for supporting actress for The Curious Case of Benjamin
and
Button.
I saw that
movie. She was great.
It.
She was great in that.
And Viola Davis also was
from
nominated
Doubt.
For Doubt.
Right.
So congratulations
right.
to them.
That's beautiful. Anytime you can be black people. Anybody, black people, white, anybody, whenever you can be nominated for an Oscar, it's fantastic.
Absolutely.
I don't care how you feel or who should have won. Whenever anybody can be nominated, because there's hundreds and thousands of movies being made right now as we speak. Hundreds of movies are being out on the theater. Anybody can be nominated.
Yeah, Cat Williams got a movie out.
Anybody that can win an Oscar is fantastic.
And Taraji has really been doing her thing.
Yes,
she has really been doing her thing.
From Baby
thing.
Boy,
yes.
She was great in that movie.
Yes. She was great in Benjamin Button. What
yeah,
do you call it? Benjamin Button.
The Curious
Button.
Case Benjamin of Button. Benjamin
Button. That movie was fantastic. The
movie was great.
And congratulations to her. It's tough.
That's what I'm saying. Anything you could be nominated for or win an Oscar for or a Grammy, because there was time we wasn't winning Oscars. We wasn't winning Grammys.
Weren't even nominated.
You know, from Hattie McDaniel, from Gone with the Wind, until we can keep on going on. Anytime, and people say, well, she wanted paying a maid. And my mother said, would you rather play a maid or be a maid?
Message.
Anytime.
There it is.
And I love my mother. Anytime you can do anything, black folk, and be recommended, and be, now you ain't gonna say it. Anytime you can win anything, black people. Anytime you can be nominated for anything, other black folks, shut the fuck up. Don't knock them down.
So
because the same girls that say Hollis should have won it for a monster's ball, ask that bitch when she had took that part. And every bitch that says no is sitting on my couch right now for a lesser part.
I love Halle Berry. I support.
You was nominated for Best Criminal, wasn't you?
Hey, you right, Speedy. I was whatever you can win. I got a get out of jail free card. I accept that. Black folks, we gotta embrace. It's like they're doing about the Barack, and he's not black. He's from
embrace.
His father's from
embrace.
Whatever. Come on, y'all. Let's
just
embrace.
Stop bitching.
Stop.
Yes. Stop bitching.
Let me ask you, what are you doing, nigga?
Yeah.
Right.
He's yeah. not black enough for you. Well, how black are you? You didn't even run, nigga. What did you do? You and all your blackness, you didn't even get no black eyed peas, nigga.
You didn't even vote.
You didn't even vote.
Didn't even vote. Shut the fuck up.
You couldn't vote.
How black are you, nigga? Let's see you and all your black supremeness.
Go run.
Go run.
And see how much dirt they pull up on your ass.
You're stinking that. I can't. Ooh.
Go run for prom king.
And start with that. Yeah. Yeah. Like the DUI class president. Yeah. Run for that, nigga.
Rite Aid night manager.
Be a greeter at the fucking mall, nigga. How about that?
Employee of the day.
Hey, you know what? I love this serious radio show.
I'm not leaving.
I know the time has come.
Let's
go
for a drink.
Ooh, I love the controversy. I love the argument. I love the fact that Paul has even raised her voice. She said, if you motherfuckers won't let me read, I'm going to go smoke some more weed.
Every day.
Every day.
She was fired up about that.
Yeah,
and,
she was kinda mad.
I'm glad Speedy and Claudia got a chance to represent Sirius.
I'm really
the
jealous.
Foxhole.
And thank you too, Sirius and XFM. We appreciate
it. It's XM,
XM,
nigga.
XFM.
God damn. XM.
I always want to put the F in there.
Extra food and mayonnaise. What is that for?
XM 140.
Extra fondue.
French toast. Filet mignon. Frankfurters. Fish and chips.
Fuck.
He said Frankfurter.
Extra fucking meat.
Prescriptive.
What's funny about it is extra stuff with an E. And shout out to my boy, Jamie Foxx, who make this all possible for us to be here today.
He did.
Fox is shooting a movie in Philly. So I know it's cold out there, Fox. So make sure you take care. Make sure you, and if you ain't got it,
drink. Oh, I'm sorry.
Go out and get the Jamie Foxx CD Intuition.
Don't touch me.
Please, we need this.
Dirty.
We need this album to do great things. It was the Unpredictable was fantastic.
Yeah. Right.
Let's just get Unpredictable.
Keep This was my favorite. No, I'm kidding.
Yeah, the Hot Top Fade, it got to be recognized. That's the beginning of Buns. Trust me. So, if you out there.
The Booty Call soundtrack was off the chain.
It was. You got to go out and get Jamie Foxx CD. Intuition, and make sure we support Jamie Foxx and his new movie coming out, because the soloist should be out in April
months,
in a couple
April.
Months.
Yeah. I gotta see.
Hey, you, because in the Benjamin Button movie, they show the trailer.
Oh, they do.
And the movie he's working on right now is with F. Gary Gray called Law Abiding.
And
Law
Abiding. And from the big dude from 300.
From 300, without the six pack.
And speaking of Jamie being out in Philly, my homegirl called me today. She said, "Jamie, if you need some girls to come over to your trailer and take care of you, she got you."
Well, tell her to hold on, because I'm flying out there for the Super Bowl weekend. And let us send a flock of them Phillies down to the trailer.
Hey, what song should we end with?
They're going to come. You should make sure they come.
Number one.
Is Speedy coming? Yeah. Is Speedy going to Philly with you?
I can't speak on.
Oh, okay.
I can't fit him in my backpack.
Okay.
You know, we're gonna end with my favorite.
Bring
song.
Some cheese steaks and.
We're gonna end it on this next release. Blame it. I'm sorry, Claudia. Blame it on the alcohol.
I can't blame on the alcohol anymore. I can't blame
Lewis
on the alcohol.
Dix,
anymore.
Buddy Lewis.
Shooting the video, right?
Shut up, fatty.
Well, Claudia, before we go out of here, we gotta make sure we get the bezel piece
again.
Yeah.
Yeah. Is this the fourth time I gotta read this?
Well, they're on your watch right there. You're gonna get a wristband. That's what you're gonna get.
Your hand just fell off the watch.
Speedy, pipe down and tell your stomach to shut the fuck up right now, too. I read this.
What the fuck?
Nigga got bubble guts.
Wow. It's been 20 minutes since the last
Hold it. I'm not gonna sit there and let you talk about Speedy like
that. Let's take your last step from Jurassic Park. Claudia.
Let Speedy read it.
Yeah, why don't you read the Speedy?
We got an hour left. Go.
That nigga can't say that name.
Say, and try Odomar. Try Odomar.
You like the Lamar Odom watch.
The Odomar.
Make sure you get the I'd Be Gay watch.
Lamar Odom.
Don't be gay. Don't get the get. I'm his gay watch.
Go ahead, Claudia. Just do the thing.
Let's do it.
The holidays are here, and that means that Valentine's Day will be here before you know it. And most guys won't be ready. Audemars Piguet, the world's oldest luxury watchmaker, still in the hands of its founding family, will make this holiday timeless. Audemars Piguet invites you to enter to win his and her Audemars Piguet watches this Valentine's Day on Sirius.com/AP. Not familiar with Audemars Piguet? AP is known for its daring achievements, record number of world's firsts, and celebrity loyalties. One lucky listener will win a pair of Audemars Piguet Royal Oak watches with a combined value of almost $25,000. His watch is a classic in stainless steel with its iconic octagonal bezel. Her Royal Oak has the added sparkle of 32 diamonds. Make this Valentine's Day one to remember. Enter today to win a pair of Audemars Piguet Royal Oak watches this Valentine's Day on Sirius.com/AP. No purchase necessary. Must be at least 18 and a resident of the lower 48 states or D.C. to enter. Entry deadline is February 12th, 2009. See official rules at Sirius.com/AP.
Beautiful.
That was wonderful.
And meat.
Beautiful, Claudia. That was a great read, Claudia. So, we about to get out. So, Chris Spencer, tell our listeners where they come in. You come to their city, next time you be out, tell them more about Chris Spencer. Where can we find you?
Well, when they're in L.A., I'm at the Savoy every Tuesday in Inglewood, 214 South La Brea, one block south of Manchester.
Mm.
This week we got Tommy Davidson.
Yeah. Bring your pistol.
It's a two-bullet minimum.
Listen, it is not. Everybody thinks because you say Inglewood, it's going to be thugs.
No, it's Manchester that's too.
It's actually the thugs' parents that will be here. So.
There you go. And they've cleaned their life up now.
Yes.
Claudia, where can we find you?
Mondays right here on Sirius and XM 149, the Claudia Jordan Show. Deal or No Deal, I think it's still running. And March 1st is episode 1 of Celebrity Apprentice Season 2, so check that out.
So network is that?
Both on NBC.
Oh, great.
The real networks.
Cool. Did you win the money? Did you win?
I can't tell you what happened on the show, but I cussed the white bitch out.
Well, you just told us what happened on the show.
I can say that, though. I wanted to punch
Give us the initials of the white bitch you cussed out.
Melissa Rivers.
But you can't say it on. But you can't say it on the show.
Can't say the initials. She can say their name. But
she can't say the initials.
Initials illegal.
Nah.
Who's Melissa's? Who's that?
That's Joan Rivers' daughter.
Yeah, you know Joan Rivers? She looks like a poodle. She has a little baby. It looks just like her. I've seen them both poodle. Without makeup.
She looks like Madam.
Hysterical.
I've seen these bitches with no makeup. And when I tell you,
they're a bit like Jim Carrey.
without the mask.
Let me show you something.
Fire Marshal Bill. Shit.
Speedy's always somewhere. You know, because last Friday he was on the road.
He's somewhere and nowhere at the same time.
That's because he's fatties everywhere. Speedy, when can we find you doing your thing?
Besides
Speedy?
Wednesday nights at 7 o'clock on Speedy's Comedy Corner, I'll be in Oakland. In Fairfield at the Air Force Base with Mr. Michael Collier on the 20th.
Right.
So make sure you get there. And Celestine's on the 19th. So Celestine's is in Oakland, and that's right by Hager Burger.
Yep.
Used to be called Hungry Burgers.
Used to be called Hungry Hunters.
Yeah, now it's Celestine's.
Right.
And the next day, we're going to be at Travis Air Force Base, and one show only, and just be me and Michael. We're going to be doing it.
February the 20th and February the 19th.
A lot of fellas there, huh?
Yes. And hopefully All-Star Weekend, we're putting something together to get the crew down to All-Star Weekend.
I depend on you to do that, Speedy.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, because I got some chicks in Phoenix, man. And
I got a house out there for rent, baby.
You don't want to rent the house to us, what I'm about to do.
Hit me on the MySpace page.
You're going to need some Luminol when I get this motherfucker.
God damn. Well, I need all the money.
There's going to be DNA all over this Luminol.
All the money up front.
What is on the chandelier?
Hey, don't worry about that, Speedy.
What
this is going.
What is this red stuff?
Poetess.
Y'all can check me out at myspace.com/OG Poetess. And Young Dude's holler. She's open now.
So, so what's up with the Young Dude? You going to let him?
He was cool.
You gonna
I really enjoyed
you going to let him
day.
Peek through the meat curtain?
We are
you gonna let her do what?
That sounds nasty.
Peek through the meat curtain.
Oh my
with
God.
The beads. She got beads.
Johnny Mac, you pearl. Just got the Bud Light joke of the day.
About time. I have been trying for 2 years. Give it up for me for my first
time. I've never heard that, Johnny Mac. What does it sound
nasty. Say it again, Johnny.
You're going to let him peek through the meat curtain.
Peekaboo!
You gotta love that one, Portis. But you gonna let the young dude?
Lewis has never looked at that curtain.
I don't know. I mean, we just went on our first date, so it was cool.
He didn't fuck on the first date?
How long does it take?
I fucks on the first date.
Hey, no, you don't.
I
can't tell you what was really on my mind, but you know.
Claudia won.
I don't know why.
He's cool. He's cool. He might have a chance.
John, did I tell you me and Claudia hooked up while we was in D.C.?
Yeah. Here's a question. Who's on top?
Well, I'm still alive, so I'd have to be on top.
Because I know your pelvis got a weight limit on that.
Exactly. I don't have a titanium pelvis.
So fucking quick.
You said titanium.
Shit, fucking diamond bezel pelvis.
I got to make a phone call to Diamond Double D, too. Remind me to make a phone call.
Oh, what? Mm.
Buddy Lewis.
She don't have a
yes,
phone?
Sir.
Buddy Lewis.
1-800-TIE.
Got pigeons calling her.
She just got like a
you know. Just say it, what happened?
Buddy Lewis, I know you're doing great things in your career.
Random.
He's eating.
Tell me, what we going to find you at next, buddy? You got a gang of things.
On the March 26th, Big Stand with Rob Schneider comes out on DVD. And I'm famous in 6 countries, Budapest, the Philippines, and Australia.
That's all places already, where people are hungry.
I know.
And where they rape boys.
And
they all got unibrow.
And they all watching my movie, so I don't give a shit.
Real to real?
And I just got back.
I think I got a talking slideshow, man.
Right here is a Bucky Lewis. A Bucky Lewis.
What are movies can be
Black Dynamite.
And I'm also just got back from the Sundance Film Festival, of course, where the movie with Mike Jai White, Tommy Davidson, Chris Spencer, myself, Ken Whitley, we all it's going to be out soon. Please go to the trailer www.blackdynamite and check it out.
It
that's
going
to be out soon. It's going to be real funny. It's an ode and a homage to the old blaxploitation movie. So it's going to be great. A lot
Congratulations.
Of fun.
Hey, make sure you check out Buddy Lewis and check out Claudia Jordan on her show. And everything else she said, make sure you check out Speedy because he's always going to be in your city. Hey, have you ever seen Speedy on the road?
Killer.
That nigga kills. Thanks, Speedy God. On the road is just in here where I die.
Exactly.
So, man,
but on the
always,
road.
You always get nice to him towards the end. Is he your ride home?
No, I can't remember right. Paul. Yeah,
no.
Yeah.
One thing you cannot deny is Speedy on the road.
Speedy on the road.
Beast.
He actually was better when he did a show in D.C.
It's just in town when industry matters.
Yeah. Because on the road, they don't say action. They say action here, Speedy fall apart like a loose Halloween mask.
But Johnny Mac, but if I peek through what?
Meat curtain. What was my song I said?
Do the song.
I can't remember.
And Chris Spencer in the morning, one of the most funny,
he's a great host.
Clever host. If you know what? I'm gonna put this out there. If you are wherever you are,
and you
if
need
you
us.
Want us to come host your club, yes. host your party, host your comedy club,
Bar
or your
mitzvah.
Comedy show,
we need cash. Portis, we need cash.
Portis, tell them how they can reach us. Any one of us, of all of us collectively, give them the MySpace or the email.
Pick me.
Well, get yours. Give yours.
You guys can hit me up at myspace.com/OGPoetess if you want to reach any of the guys for any gigs. I'll take my little cut.
Yeah, and your internet. Give me your internet thing.
That's it.
I thought it was MySpace. The same thing.
That's what's
we also have MySpace. A Facebook page.
There's an unofficial Foxhole page, but I don't know. Should leave us a comment.
Yo, you know what? Tune in next week, and we're going to give you all that information.
Well, go to Speedy is Funny.
Yeah, MySpace.
Yeah. This is MySpace / Speedy is Funny. That's Speedy IZ Funny.
That means he's going to see 50%. We got this.
Yeah, so that's how you can reach us, because we want to go out, man. We want to come to your city, man.
Host events.
Host events, host your parties, and you can have all this right here live and in your face, man. And if you in Phoenix,
you
want something
through the meat curtain.
You want something to go down for you at the All-Star Weekend, hey, man, get a hold of these cats. That way you just said, we're going to get the information, because we're going to go out with all this great comedy and do some great gigs.
Meat curtain tour.
Yeah.
Don't let Suge Knight get out.
Hey, it's been a blast, man. Thank everybody that listened.
Johnny Dunk, you did a great job.
Hey, thank you, Speedy.
Listen, we never thank Guy Black and Greg Sheldon for producing.
Well, why should we start now?
Yeah, okay. That's what I'm saying.
That's true.
Barack said change, not a choice.
You know the brains behind this operation.
Yeah.
Mark King,
Stonewash,
executive producer Greg
Pumpkin.
Shelton.
Yeah, shout out to Greg Shelton.
Millions and millions of other things. I'm
shout
glad
out to Guy Black. You can catch Guy Black on
the. And you got to give the.
The nigga with the black eye.
Give it up for Noriega.
Yeah. The dude that wasn't in Menudo. Yo, please.
Mexican punch.
If y'all want to catch us, man, come out.
What did you say?
He called him Mexican punch.
He's a practice dummy that real boxes box on.
Pinata punch. Yo, that's our show, man. Make sure you tune in to us next week on Sirius Radio. God bless you. We'll be back next week. Peace.